We ended up, you guys entered the Tomb of Horrors, a strange crypt or dungeon located on a hillside on an island in the continent of Warren. There was a few false entrances to it, but you guys found your way in, went through a strange and mysterious hallway where Kai, the barbarian, so we're using a new map I found, and here's where you guys, in this tunnel that you went through, and I had to remove the roof to this hill, because I had to go in and put all the hidden zones in. So there's quite a bit of work just to get through it. And you guys kind of figure it out. You can see the pit traps and stuff down below here as well. So I use my flashlight. I don't want to turn the darkness level up, just because, so you can see what's kind of going on. So then you guys found a secret doorway here behind one of the frescoes, went through a room of traps, and I just had you guys do a single roll, but you can see, like, one way to do it is, like, you go through each room, and you have to roll, like, a dex save on each room as these spike traps are coming out. But you guys made it to this mysterious hallway, and what this artist did, if you look closely, is he did a lot more detailed work to this than the other map that I was using. He actually put the circles on the walls, right? So I thought to myself, like, and then there was, of course, you know, mysterious, and you can see here, there was, like, kind of this strange, that he did a good job with the mist effect at the very end of the hallway here. You guys found a secret doorway in one parts of the hall, went down here, traversed all the way to this strange, for lack of a better word, temple or church. It's got an altar at the very end. And I'll just show you guys we'll see what you guys want to do. Here's what it looks like in darkness, right? So it's a lot harder to see. But I think that's probably not the best way to do it. I think we should actually turn up the lights a little bit so we can actually appreciate, because a lot of you guys have dark vision for starters. Plus, this can be kind of a challenging map dungeon and stuff like that. And just not being able to see stuff is difficult. There is a skeleton here. There are pews in, you know, this structure is built, you know, in this big hill. Around you is essentially earth and stuff that's all been excavated out. And this is what the crypt sounds like. And I'll describe kind of where you're at a little bit more. Give me a second. Anybody else want to add anything to it? Did I miss something? Why don't we go around the table real quick? We'll start off with Morgan. Tell us a little bit. We need kind of a refresher. What does your character look like? And tell us about as much as you want about your character.
Sure. Would you mind subbing in the figure? It looks like we have the temporary figure that was there last week.
Yeah, give me one second. Let's see. Sometimes we have connection issues with that. Okay. And I don't see your figure in here, so I might have to restart. Do you want me to try to restart?
It's up to
you. Do you have the Talespire account linked to your thing and everything? All right, let me try to restart
here. You downloaded into this game?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool. So you can go into the builder yourself and see your model, correct? Is that how you see it, Ray?
I press spacebar, open the Hero Forge tab at the bottom left, and then I see the chain link on my character.
Do you see your character there?
I do not.
So it's not linked in then?
Okay. Do I have to refresh? Is that what'll do it?
How does it work, Ray?
So it should just be real time.
Okay.
So you got your Hero Forge account linked in?
Yeah, I took the link from Hero Forge and put it into the Talespire in the gear settings. It's about a third of the way down.
And then you downloaded the digital file of your character?
Yeah, it's on my local machine.
Oh, so you downloaded the STL then, it sounds like?
No, I downloaded the... It's a Unity 3D file.
So... then that is the correct one. How long ago did you do it?
It shouldn't be the Unity 3. It should be the digital download part, right?
Yeah.
So it should be under your digital download. I think it is. You download the STL, right?
Can you go into, Kai, can you go into Hero Forge and tell him if you got the right one?
Yeah, I'm going that out.
Yeah, I'm going over there as well. I don't want to take up too much time from everybody, so it's not a big deal. We can do this.
It's one of those things, like, if you don't get it right away, Morgan, as we play, you can, like, try to fiddle with it.
Yeah.
And say we'll get it. We'll probably get it in by the end of the session. What is your character all about? What does he look like? Sure. What race is he? All that stuff.
He's a half elf, bard 9 levels, 1 level of warlock. It's a kind of a College of Swords warlock bard. He's carrying a set of bagpipes. I used the 12,000 bucks that you gave us. I bought a flame touched longsword that's in his right hand, and a dancing short sword in his left. He's dashingly handsome with an 18 charisma.
How old is he?
He is, I'd say he's in his, you know, he's in his 30s maybe as far as half elves go. But he's a performer. He's one of those like tavern guys that you would see, and he's kind of famous, relatively famous.
I just watched episode 6 of The Witcher with the bard in it. I love that guy.
So yeah, that's pretty much him. He's kind of out to make some money and learn, you know, have some stories to tell while he's out doing his thing on the stage.
What a great story to tell, entering one of the most famous dungeons in all of Dungeons and Dragons, the Meat Grinder, known as the Tomb of Horrors. Kai, why don't you tell us a little bit about your character a little bit?
Mine's a Kalishka Barbarian. He's pretty beefy, as you can see from the
the Conan the Barbarian model. Yes.
Yeah. He's a total warrior finger. Sorry, I was trying to focus on Hero Forge, but yeah, that's pretty much all I got.
Muscles, grease, and 80s action.
Yeah.
Armor's for pussies. Rutherford, what does your character look like?
Older, classy gentleman that is a merchant by trade and came from a background of being a physician. A bit of the eccentric side and is really just out looking for adventure now in his kind of retirement age with a history of blade singing.
His feet are on this... You're sitting on the chair. You haven't kicked your feet up onto the unholy altar of some strange church of worship. A skeleton like lies over to your left, you know, in front of one of these strange, eerie doors that robbed Kai of every magical item and all physical items on him. He came out of the other side butt naked last game. Corridor, you want to change your name to
twice
to Cypher.
Cypher,
what does your character look like, and what is he all about?
My character is a black dragonborn. He is skinnier than what you'd seen most dragonborns would be, but a lot stealthier. He's a lot more in it for the money. You can see that he's a lot of rags, tatters. His armor is like heavily patched up, but has really enough have like nice things around him. Pretty much anything that might be useful to him are the only nice thing he has, and he's pretty just much in it for the money, but at the same time he won't do anything to like screw the mission over.
You guys are in a place called the Chapel of Evil. What you see is obviously some form of a temple area. There are scenes of normal life painted on the walls, but the people have rotting flesh and skeletal hands. Worms are eating them from their inside out. There is also depicted various religious symbols of good alignment. There is also a mosaic path leading between the four rows of wooden pews that face the worship area. In front of the pews are wooden railings that divide the room. South is the altar of a tiered dais, which sits a wooden chair, which you're sitting on. As you get close to the chair, I'll describe the chair a little bit more. The chair is nicely carved and padded, but seems unremarkable. On either side of the dais are large freestanding, large brass candelabras, each holding 5 white candles. In each corner of the southern wall is a large white pottery urn, stoppered with a brass and wood plug. Sprawled on the floor near the west wall is a human skeleton in black chainmail that is badly rusted and damaged. The skeleton's outreached arms point towards a stone archway set into the wall. The opening is filled with opaque, bright orange vapors. What do you guys do?
One side conversation in the Discord for Dallas. I put 2 images of what your Hero Forge and Talespire should look like to have your character.
Thanks. I'll fiddle with it. Appreciate it.
So here's how I want to roll. Like dungeons, and like especially a dungeon like this, there are a lot of secret doors, secret traps, like we saw from last game. How it'll work is once your model is close to one, I'll roll something in secret. If you're kind of high, I'm going to give... I want to write down all your modifiers for perception. So this is just to spot it. And then it's so that you kind of get close to it by moving your model around. That'll be the roll. Now, if you guys are just like, hey, we're kind of hitting a dead end because like we didn't see anything, you can go back and we'll add like more time to it. Similar to like taking 10 and taking 20 and 3.5, if you remember those rules. Morgan, what's your perception?
Passive?
Well, no. We're not using passive perception.
Oh, right. You don't like that.
I don't like it.
It's plus 9. Plus 9.
Kai?
I?
What is your perception modifier?
My perception modifier is... plus 7.
Rutherford?
2.
And Cypher?
Plus 10.
Cool.
Expertise.
And this is something just sort of arbitrarily that I will kind of do. What do you guys do?
I just sit on the chair.
I've described the chair. The candles flicker and burn. Obviously, Rutherford, they must be magical. Continual flame, perhaps.
I pull out a cigar and light one up on the candle on the left.
It's fine tobacco. What land is it from?
The land of my hometown of Persepolis.
I love the name. Must be from Laria, the land of the West.
Well, gentlemen, I would prefer you all scout around, see what you can find. My old eyes aren't as good as they used to be.
I'll take a look at what I presume looks like an altar. Just take a look around at it.
It's glowing blue. You see, like, obviously, Cypher, this room, this must have been a place of worship for the Lich. Or for Vecna, right? It's empty now and forgotten. Maybe he sat in this chair where Rutherford was once sat, gathering admiration from his followers. The altar beyond that is dark and black, but it glows with a blue hue of magic.
And there's a body over here.
Yes, with blackened chainmail.
I'll guess I'll take a look at it.
It appears just to be normal chainmail.
Can I do an arcana check on the altar in front of me, since there's apparently a magical black hue?
Roll it up.
Would you like an assist?
Yeah.
The natural 2.
There we go. Where's the game log?
You just roll right, it directly from roll. Your. You just roll it directly yeah. from your character sheet. I have the game log pulled up.
Yep, it's. I rolled a 10.
Yep, you just You don't have it set to public roll. That was Rutherford's roll, so you have to click that button.
Yeah, I get it. Public. Okay. All right, let me try it again, see if it works this time. Do you see it now?
No. I do not. You have to go to, I believe, the lower... You have the combat log toggled, right? Mm-hmm. And lock it. I hit the little lock button to lock it. There's usually a toggle switch right below there from a select box. Yep. You select that from self to everyone and then re-roll
it. It's on everyone now.
Okay, try to roll it again.
Let me refresh the page as well.
Cool.
Might be a problem.
It's all good. There's a lot going on. Multiple monitors are nice to have in this type of game.
Yeah, I've got four monitors going. All right, so I just checked it. It does say everyone. And
just try to do a little roll.
No game activity yet. All right, let's try it.
I don't see your roll yet.
That's wild. It's not showing up in the game log at all now. Let's see. I will toggle at the Game Master and roll again, see if you see it.
I do see your model, the Tailspire model that you used.
Good.
I do not see you roll it, but see, I'm going to go to your character sheet right now and I'll roll it for you. As you are a bard, you have proficiency. Did I just roll it for him? Did it show for you guys or no?
Yeah.
He rolls a 21.
Okay.
Morgwine, you kind of take a look at it. I mean, obviously, this is some foul shit. Like, little skeletons of, like, maybe small animals. The wallpaper itself, old, ancient, must be centuries old. Yet the building itself, built deep in the mountain somewhere. Maybe this is where Vecna got his beginning. Hidden away.
Good observation, Morgwine. I gotta make a call. I'll be right back.
This is vile. Perhaps the beginning of Vecna himself.
Something that wouldn't be fun to mess with. I'll start looking around the walls, see if there's anything unique about them. Just find anything that might help us with this.
You spend a few minutes, like, looking around all the walls, and you see, like, these strange urns and stuff, and the pews are awfully weird. But you do find a secret door. Or something secret, I should say. So I see I rolled that for you since you kind of announced it. That's kind of how I'm trying to do this. And what I'm doing is I'm saying that you're always kind of checking for stuff. And every time I approach like a trap or something, like one of these pit traps or something, I'll roll your perception roll. Whoever's like the first in line, which is this cipher from last game. There appears to be like a wall slot. It has a faint letter O traced above it. What do you do?
I mean, first I would see if it is at all trapped, especially being in this room of the Lich.
All is well.
I will inform the others about my discovery. But even though I feel like it might be well, seeing this weird crest above it, I don't know what it would mean.
What do you guys do?
I don't feel like there's anywhere else to go but forward from here.
There's a strange door here filled with vapor. Then there's this other. Maybe you'd look kind of beyond it. Do you have dark vision, Cypher?
I have dark vision from Rusford from his spell.
Cool. You look through the hole and you do see it. It's like a secret door of some type. Like you see a cavern way, you know, like, is that a stairway that goes down further?
I'll open the door.
You like pull on the hole in the wall. Nothing happens.
I'll see if I can unlock it with my thieves tool.
You begin to search around the frame of the door for like a keyhole or way as you kind of like slip your thieves tools into your mouth, right? No keyhole.
Maybe we need a bludgeon in.
Didn't you say there's a slot there?
Oh yeah, is there a slot?
There's a hole.
Circular?
It's a circular hole.
Something in it?
It's just empty?
You look through and you see the stairway.
Okay. Maybe something in here can probably fit it. I'm not fully sure.
I reveal the stairway like that. Right? You see that now?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So, either there might be a way to open it, or we just might need to force it.
You look over to the right, Cypher, you see this pile of skulls, right? Put up in the room. Mm-hmm. Left here long ago. They have no facial expression on them because they have no skin left. The rats would have gotten them by now.
Is there anything in this room that, I mean, might sound silly, but is there anything in this room that might seem like it would fit it?
I'll make another roll, like you guys like looking around a little bit. So there's no sound effect when I make this secret roll, right? So I roll it, but there's actually no sound effect. You look around, like there's some festoons, there's pews, and you go to like, you're just kind of like looking high and low a little bit. Let me see what we got here.
Down like look under the pews where they usually hide books.
All the benches have hinge seats. That is all. And of course there's the skeleton pointing his way to this doorway here. Besides that, the room is just, it's like no church you've ever been in on the mainland. You know, this is a place of worship of the dead for those who wish to cheat life.
Well, you got any idea, Morgwin?
Well, there's hinges on the seats.
Yeah, seems like
a like a door, like there's compartments.
Yeah, like there's compartments.
Yeah, I guess like I would guess there. I mean, might look through it. Might there be any information, books? Since this, they would usually hide small information about what they would worship.
Do you want to open them?
Yeah.
Want to check them?
Roll the investigation roll if you want to check for traps, Cypher.
Alrighty. 19.
I mean, you're pretty thorough about it. Doesn't appear to be trapped.
Then I'll just start opening them up one by one, see if I can find anything.
Cobwebs. Nothing. Another dead end.
Maybe we should just use Kai's brute strength to get us through that door. That's one of the options I see. Or risk maybe losing it all again to the vapor mist to our right.
Oh yeah, I'm not going through that way. And he points over where the skeleton is.
It's probably either the mysterious door or maybe something about this altar, but the last thing I want to do is deal with lichcraft.
Yeah. I'm not volunteering to touch that.
I don't think all of us would. So I think we're going to need to borrow Kai for the mysterious doorway.
So I'm mildly intrigued about the is it like a peephole that he sees into the next room, or is it like a slot that's supposed to be accepting something? Can I make like a separate investigation roll on the door?
Yeah, I'll roll this for you. Or it's an investigation roll?
Investigation, perception, whatever would be applicable.
It's like a circular O, a hole in the door that leads to another. You see, like a glimpse of stairs that go down. Somehow like connected into this of chapel of evil.
Is it like the size of a coin or an item?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is the size of a coin.
All right. You know what? I'm going to rummage into my pouch, and I'm just going to pull out a gold piece.
You slip it through?
Slip it through.
You're it. Change. That kind of maybe fall like a little bit down. It's gone now. It's on the other side of the wall.
Going to push on the wall a little bit.
No effect.
Well, fellas, that's all I've got.
I'd like to charge through the door. And as I get towards the door, I want to try and drop kick it.
You see Kai get impatient. His glistening muscles from the candlelight. He charges forward and does it like a WWE drop style kick. The door is like, it's like mixed with stone. Roll an athletics roll to break through the door.
Hell yeah.
To try to bust through the cement of it all.
15.
You feel it budge. Another good smacking could probably bust through it. You want to do it again?
I don't want to drop kick it this time. I want to stand with my back towards the wall and kick my foot backwards.
Like a horse?
Yeah. I get more power behind it that way than kicking forward.
Roll it with advantage. You try to mule kick the secret entrance way down.
Yeah.
Yeah. 22. You know, you feel like one of your foot slip, then you crack right through it, and enough space has been created. You want to keep cracking it open? You could fit through now.
Yeah.
It's easy for you now with your brute strength. You do another thing, and you feel the rumbling, and the door like collapses into some rubble right before you.
I look towards them and say, "Well, it's open now."
Well done.
Good job. Oh.
Rutherford, you notice that there's like a perfect symmetry between this door placement, right, and the door over here as well, right? Except for this one is a secret door. The way the architecture is laid out.
Oh, I get it.
Cypher goes in first. So I'm going to reveal the next area here.
Pick up my gold piece on the way down.
Pick it up.
The gold coin. Money, you know.
Gold piece is still there. Who's the symbol on the coin, Morgan?
It would be whatever the local currency of some faraway land that he traveled to and sang on a stage and collected it as a tip.
There's like a doorway in front of you. I'm assuming what I'm going to do is, like, again, like, I'll only make a roll. The roll will be in secret if the doorway is trapped. Otherwise, I'm assuming you're, like, checking everything. So you don't have to, like, repeat yourself, because that's kind of just how traps work. And obviously you guys are like being careful about this. Other than that, if like a trap goes off, the models are where they are. So you guys have to kind of keep that in mind too. Like there could be maybe a complex trap of some kind. Mm-hmm. You check the door. It appears to be untrapped. Do you want to open it?
Yep, I'll be on the left side, slowly pushing the door open, getting like a sneak peek before I fully open it.
Go ahead and right-click the door, and then hit open. And it gives me a little menu as the door creaks open. Dust, like, billows out a little bit. Yeah. You continue.
Is it just like another set of doors?
Yeah, you see another set of doors.
This architect, quite the obsession with doors.
Very odd.
This could be like that other room before we got to the hallway. Lots of little rooms after each other.
Gentlemen, I believe we'll want to be together between doors. In case one opening shuts behind the other.
This one, did this one open? Like, naturally?
Which one?
The one in front of us, or did I unlock it?
It's closed, if you look at it. I highlight it with my flashlight.
Yeah. No, the one that I'm directly holding it. The one I just opened.
You leave it open, it stays open.
But did I have to unlock it, or did I just push it open?
You just pushed it open. There was no lock for it.
To push, though, not pull. I was thinking about possibly using one of my arrows, but does it open this way?
Why don't we have our strong friend who's able to kick down doors hold this open while we figure out what's going on with the next one?
Well, last time I dealt with a spear flying in my face, so I'll stand behind this wall while you guys move forward to the next door.
Well, I suppose I'll take charge here.
Cypher gets a little mistaken before we go. Let me make a roll here. You take a look down. So I'm going to say the DC for noticing that any trap is 15. The whole dungeon, pretty much, just to simplify things. Before you take a look, step down, you kind of were like tapping with your foot a little bit, Rutherford. There's like a pit trap here. I think
both.
Like if I remove it like that, I don't know. You like it pulls one of the stones away, and I think it's this guy was did a really good job when he designed this when I was going through it. Let me just double check the map. It's right in front of the doorway. As you begin to just check, you catch it. It's like this, and I think I can reveal the hit. There's a hidden. So this guy put in hidden zones. Yeah, right below. So that if you want me to, I can reveal it. There's a hidden zone right below you into a pit trap. And you look, it's like water. You've hit the water table of the hill. You guys have gone down far enough. You found a trap. What do you guys do?
I'll hop over to the next one.
You make a little jump across. Fortunately, there's no trap right here.
That's what I was worried about.
Somebody do it.
Very well. I'll jump as well.
You open the door?
Yep, open the door.
Check for traps.
Holding the other door open?
Kai is like, yeah, he's right here, like trying to keep the door open. It doesn't appear to be like shutting or doing any other crazy mechanisms. Just like a simple pit trap. You check the door for traps there, Cypher. No traps. All is well.
I stumbled the same way he did, seeing if it's repetitious trap.
Yeah. Fortunately, you're very keen. There's another trap, right? Another pit trap right below. Mm. Meant to maybe catch unprepared adventurers, but not like you.
I'll hop over here, this one.
Yeah. The designer lacked creativity.
Maybe not behind this one.
We shall see.
No, try to open this door too. You guys gonna follow suit?
The door is not trapped, and who here has the, like, a keen mind? Does anybody have the keen mind feed or anything like that? Everybody makes.
I have keen mind.
Kai has keen mind. No way, the barbarian.
he has.
Are you for real? Vision. You have keen mind.
Yeah.
No, are you serious? I'm looking up your character sheet right now.
I'm pretty sure Kalishka has keen mind.
He might not have the intellectual memory, but visual memory, he can like paint.
I'm double checking this as we speak.
That's amazing.
Let me go to feats.
That was unexpected.
You do not have keen mind. You have dual wielding and mobile.
Oh, mind link. I was thinking of my thought.
Yeah, you don't.
Yeah.
Everybody rolls an insight roll. DC. This is an insight roll. We'll say that the DC is. Well, Rutherford and Morgan, all you guys rolled pretty good on this. And then Kai needs to roll as well. Kai, of course, rolls three rolls. He's super into insight. Rutherford and Morgan, you guys think about it. You both look into each other's eyes. You give yourself a look. Maybe this room, it's like kind of weird how there's three doors. You tap down again, and you see like another pit trap. Right? The same as before. Right on the other side of the door. And you think back to the riddle that you first encountered in the beginning of the dungeon. Maybe there's something to do with this riddle.
I actually have it open.
You guys want me to pull it up?
We can find it on the...
You scroll a bit up. I mean, two pits along the way will be found to lead to a fortuitous fall, so check the wall. That was the first one. These keys are those that are most important of all, and beware of trembling hands and what will maul. That's the thing that ate her arm. If you find the false, you find the true, and into the calm hall you'll come, and there the throne that key and keyed. I feel like let's talk about how we went through the columns and entered the little religious ceremony. Then the iron men of visage grim do more than meets the viewer's eye. You've left and left found my tomb, and now your soul will die. Iron men of visage grim do more than meets the viewer's eye. Is there something more to this place than we're not seeing? Like, what's in this water that we've been hopping over?
Very good. Give me a second, I'm putting Morgan's model out. He's at the very end, you guys. You guys see his model now? He's over here.
Thank you.
Let me kind of put a little spotlight on him. He's really cool looking. He's got like bagpipes. Let me take a look here. Let me kind of zoom into him a little bit more so I can see him. I need to put up.
Did you pull mine across too?
Did you make one?
Yeah, I even pulled my account across.
Really? Barbarian Kalishar. Oh, you guys all have models. Wow. You don't want the Arnold Schwarzenegger model?
I did at first, and I did find one similar to
somebody. But we peer pressured you.
Yeah, I wanted to.
You got peer pressure. Let's take a look at the Kalishar model, too. Take a look here. I can pull it out. This is a cool model. You're dual wielding? Yeah, because that's what your model is. You have like a head of, are you human?
I am human. It's like a helmet sort of thing.
I love it. Got like a wolf head.
I wanted the one with the bear, but it didn't look as great.
Cool. Very good though, Cypher, as you kind of question, you're like, hey, is there something we're not looking down? You kind of look down into the pits, like before you kind of looked at this third pit, you look down, it like goes deeper. And I will reveal the hidden zone. You see this now? It's very hard to see. How it works, guys, is we go underwater. if we want to go in there. So you can't see it that well from this model, right? But when we go underwater, the camera opacity changes and we see underwater.
I don't feel like we would go forward anymore. I think we go down.
Oh, there's still room to go forward, right?
But I think it's just leading us to a trap.
You'd be the one to know, wouldn't you?
You look down the hallway, Cypher. It does go off to the right. So there does appear to be a more way to go. But you do look down, like, is there more down there?
I mean, the riddle could be a trap in and of itself, but for as now, it's only gave us clues to what could harm us and lead us to the right direction.
Well, no time like the present. I'll jump into the...
Flash. Now, move your character around. See if the camera readjusts and so you can actually see it. Can you breathe underwater, or are you just swimming down there, kind of looking? Rutherford?
I would use... Can I use shape water to create an air bubble around my head?
As a cantrip?
Yeah.
It doesn't really work like that. Okay. So, it depends on how hardcore you guys want me to be.
I get that.
Rutherford, you're always trying to tell me to be hardcore? Doesn't work. Now, Morgween, we do have a part of Zin's house rules. We have a way to do overcasting. It's a particular way to go outside the spell description. Does Rutherford want to overcast the spell to create a little ball around him? It's a way to explain magic and how to expand magical arts.
Right, it's like blowing higher level spell slots in addition to what the level of the spell you want to cast, and you're kind of like weirding a spell to do something that it's not intended to do originally.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's cool.
Rutherford, it's difficult, especially in the darkness of the water down there. Unless you have some way to breathe underwater, it's deep. It's like 30 feet or something, right? If we use the model to scale, it's like underwater. But you just you go down under there for a minute. As you come out kind of soaked on the edge of the thing, you know there's more down there.
So let me look at the rule. What's the rule for overcasting? Is it the risk one, or can I just use a spell slot to cast my cantrip?
You just want to cast a first level spell slot?
If that'll work, then yeah.
Little bottle, yeah, just mark a spell slot as you kind of enhance the spell of the cantrip. A little, you know, water thing kind of comes around. It's not like just encasing your head, kind of like a little aqua helmet. You can go down underwater for a bit. I'm going to say every hour you have to waste a level one spell slot.
Okay.
Unless someone has like, here's the thing, guys, this is meant to challenge you.
Right. Actually, I want to give it to Cypher since he also has the dark vision.
You cast it on him as well, so you both have the effect. You have to use another first level spell slot or a second level spell slot, right? You see what I'm saying? Unless you guys start using spells or abilities to breathe underwater.
While they're going through the underwater section, I will cast message before they go off, just so they can keep in touch with us to tell us what they see, so we know what's going on while they're not around us.
So, okay, cool. So we're underwater. Let me see if I can double click your model and I can shoot underwater with you, because the camera has to readjust. Okay, cool. Yeah, see, if I go underwater, now I'm there, and I'm going to reveal this hidden zone underwater.
And I don't know if this might help, but I also get advantage on constitution checks.
Yes. So what's happened is, so I just revealed the model some more, and you're just searching around under there, Rutherford. You have dark vision as well?
No, just Cypher.
So your hand is on Cypher. Around your head is encased in air that allows you to breathe for 1 hour underwater. Cypher is there with the dark vision. He is searching. He finds underwater a secret door to his left, and then straight ahead there's a way for him to go straight. Let me just double check kind of where we're at. So yeah, apparently this right here is a secret door. I'm gonna move you down. Oops, I messed up. Let me move you back, Cypher. So what's happening is I have to reveal more stuff. As we kind of do theater of the mind a little bit. And we also have to do this a little bit because this is a complex dungeon, guys.
Are you able to enable them fly so it almost looks like they're swimming rather than...
Yeah, let me do that. Give me a second. This is complex, guys. I'm trying to figure this out myself.
It's all good.
Worries.
How dare you?
Sorry, okay, bitch.
Sorry. The hidden, so here's the problem, too, is the hidden zones is a little tricky. Come on. Why is that not working?
It's because you got too many layers over the top of those, Sam.
Yeah, I do. Let me see if that one works. There we go. So straight ahead, this is what it looks like. I'm going to grab Cypher and them off the ground if I can. Put them back up.
Stuck in the bottom of the ocean.
Yeah, you're drowning now. Let me grab. Where'd the other guy go? Let me double click everybody. Make sure we're good. Morgween is there. Who are we missing? Is everybody accounted for? Is everybody up? Okay. So, you see the secret door right in front of you. You spot, and you, this is what happens. What do you guys do?
I look at Rusford. I point at the door that is secret, and I point towards the direction that is leading to Royal Hallway. And I kind of like throw up my hands in the air, like, I don't know which one.
I just point my rapier forward. Let's just go.
All right, and I push forward.
So here's what I'm going to do under the suggestion of you guys. I'm going to turn you into flying model, so it's kind of like you're swimming. How is the group breathing underwater is the question. We figured out a solution that Rutherford is going to cast shape water around people, but it's going to be very spell slot intensive. Now, how I'll do it, let's look up
the druid.
Yeah, she's not here. So you're SOL. Does anybody have an ability to breathe underwater?
I mean, the only thing it would help by, I don't know, like having advantage on constitution.
Let me look up the water breathing spell. Water breathing is a third level spell, Rutherford. Mm. And what I'll do is, since you don't have it, you can cast it up to 10 people. So I'm going to change what we've did a little bit. If you want instead, you don't have the spell, but if you want to use a fourth level spell slot, I'll allow you to cast water breathing on everyone. It lasts for one day.
But I maximum get my two first levels back.
Yes, you'll get your two first level back. So you're trading off a fourth. Normally it would be a third level spell slot, but you don't have the spell, I'm assuming, listed. Because you're not, you guys are just kind of ill-prepared, I guess.
Well, I did have 7 potions of water breathing, but yeah, I lost them all.
So if you guys can, move your models underwater. And
everybody's got water breathing for a fourth level.
Yeah. And how it works when you're swimming underwater like this, you use the control key to move yourself down. If you guys want me to do that, do you guys want to use it as a flying model like this, or is it easier to do it not flying?
I like it flying.
Okay. So everybody, please move their model there. Yes, good.
Are we missing anybody? Your cameras. They. Okay. All right.
So you're just kind of, I'm pivoting it down beneath the surface of the water, so I'm submerged, and I'm trying to do that, and then you're using the control thing. So let me kind of describe what's going on here. As you're going down this underwater cavern, for brevity's sake, I'm not giving any beyond, like, say if combat breaks out or anything like that, everything is considered normal. In other words, there's not like disadvantage to movement or attacking or anything like that. Everything kind of cancels out and we just do it as is. There's a corridor here. The corridor descends to the west and extends past the bottom. And the steps, it's like slightly cloudy down here. Do we continue?
Yeah, I'll just push forward and take a peek around this corner.
Yeah, let me reveal the zone. See, there's some steps that leads down into a room down below.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see it now.
Yeah, it's a closed door.
It's a closed door, yeah. What do you do?
I mean, if I can find, like, any loose wedge first, I'll try to, like, have my bolt that's still tightened and, like, try to shoot it in between a wedge. See if, like, if I do open a door, it's not gonna, like, suck me in.
Like a vacuum of some kind, yeah. Like you're underwater, you're worried about, like, the pressure, right, of being, like, mm-hmm. torn to bits or something, right, from the difference in pressure. But you think about the physics of it, if you were to do that, like, it would be almost impossible because the pressure here is greater than there, I guess. I mean, I make a roll in secret. Seems okay. I mean, the door does feel like it can move. The door is metal and made to last. It's made of iron, which is rusted out quite a bit. Someone can make, like, a nature roll if they want, if they're proficient in nature.
Yeah, that ain't me.
Proficient in nature, did you say?
Yeah, you have to be proficient in the skill of nature to roll it. Bards, by the way, are always considered proficient with, so Morkween can always roll because bards have the half skill feat. So you can always roll on anything.
I got minus one on prepare.
Nature?
So not me.
Why don't we have Morkween roll? He rolls a 16. Morkween, this door, it's rusted to a point. It might be like, you just think about like how you've studied other types of rust and water and stuff in the past. Maybe it's like four or five decades old.
Okay.
Is there a lock on it, even though it's super rusty?
There's no lock.
Is it locked?
There's no lock.
We can try to push or pull it.
If you tap on it, does it feel, you know how when you tap on if you're in like an above ground pool and you tap on the side, you can sense that, you know, it's not solid out on the other side of the,
like, it gives way a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does it sound hollow on the other side when you rap on it?
Tap on the, sounds like everything's fine.
I can look at him like, you want to go for it? I hold on to one of the door handles and I'll kind of like get on the ground and kind of like give a force forward with my shoulder, see if it pushes open.
Hit the head.
Can I intervene here? Wouldn't it be best if I put my two hands on the door, my 2 feet on the wall behind it?
I wouldn't think that would be the best because I feel like you should hold the other side of the handle. I'm saying that because if it does open, at least two of us can have something to hold on to if there's nothing behind it. It's just more of a precautious thing.
Okay.
There might not be anything. There might just be more water. But so I'll just do that. Somebody
open
else
can the door.
Hold up.
Yep. Right click and open the door.
Somebody want to, okay.
Oop. What else are you trying to do, Cypher, before you open it? Is anybody bracing you or anything like that?
I mean, if anybody wants to, but no, I'm opening the door.
I mean, I can brace you on the other side of the wall.
Okay. How do you brace him, Rutherford? You're kind of an old, retired adventurer, maybe not as strong as you once were.
I suggest Kai to do it.
You want me to push or brace?
Just brace you. Provide a wall closer to him. So brace yourself on this, on the wall behind him.
Yeah.
And he can push off of you.
Kai kind of gets closer to you to kind of help you if something weird happens. The door, like, opens with ease because the rusted bits come off of it. You see, Morgween, one of the rust hinges kind of snapped as you push it open. barely the door was holding together. Lying at the bottom of the stairs is an iron mace inlaid with silver. South of the location is a modest-sized room, which you can see is filled with rotted and decayed furnishings that have been soaked over the passage of time. What do you guys do? Does anybody have detect magic up or any like aura reading type stuff?
Right now.
Could it be possible if I do investigation on the door to see how heavy it is?
You like kind of, you're underwater, you have the water breathing spell on you. You're like, you pull the door just like comes right off as you take your both of your hands on the top of the door. It was barely being held together.
Am I able to carry this said door?
Yes. It would require both of your hands, so you couldn't wield a weapon. It would be an improvised weapon.
Yeah, I'd like to take it as an improvised weapon.
You already have the spear that Cypher gave you, by the way. You didn't add it to your sheet, right? Yeah, remember, but the ballista came out?
Yeah.
So you have a spear instead if you don't want to use the door.
Okay, no, I'll not use the door. I completely forgot about the spear.
The loincloth from you being butt naked swirls around you. In the water. How are you guys seeing underwater? Someone has dark vision, but who else has dark vision and stuff like that?
I have dark vision too.
Marguin?
Dark vision.
And Rothersford is the only human, right?
Yeah, I'm blind.
So how are you going to see? You're going to cast dark vision on yourself or something?
No. I'm going to just...
you're just going to go in blind. Stay close
to somebody. Yeah.
It's very dangerous to do that. You get disadvantage on all attacks. If someone else attacks you, they get advantage. And then, like, if a trap goes off, I'm going to give you disadvantage as well.
Oh, crap.
Because you're considered blinded.
I don't have dark vision.
So. I mean, Rutherford, it's a little chilly, too, under this water, right?
So two of us don't have dark vision.
Yeah, how are we going to see underwater, guys? In the dark. Don't make me switch the lights on your ass to put you in the mood.
And anyone got dancing lights still?
I assumed I wouldn't be able to put
Wasn't Cypher casting that? No, he was doing that in our other game. Who was casting that in our other this game? You were casting dancing lights?
Yeah, I mean, can I use those underwater?
Yeah.
I'm gonna lock. They're like
okay then, yeah.
So I'm not gonna put them out like we did in the other game, just to make it easy so the lights are turned up so you guys can see everything. Just to kind of help out, right? You move the lights ahead, and before I'm going to move Cypher down there, Cypher, Rutherford, you see something. There's, like, movement. What do you guys do? There's, like, a golden there's a golden couch. You swear you saw a foot.
I'd like to charge from the top step and jump over the guy in front of me.
Move your mod.
Swim over.
Yeah, swim over. I'll load my crossbow and pull out my rapier, and I'll follow right behind him. Actually, you said right...
So this is what I'm going to do. Kai has announced it. So he's swam down. So even though I do like the model of you guys swimming, right, it's really hard to do because you guys are always flying around. So I'm going to just remove the flying from you guys.
Okay, yeah. That's kind of
helpful. It's a lot harder to do. It's cool, though, but you guys can see them get in the mood with it a little bit so you guys can understand it. Everybody stop moving their models, though, as Kai charges forward. Kai, you run down the stairs, and on a couch, a golden couch, along the back wall, a skeletal figure resembling a lich wears a crown on its head, slowly rises from the couch and throws up his hands in apparent fear and the mace it is carrying. A booming voice seems to emanate the whole chamber and demands, I'm going to reveal the lich. He says, "Who dares disturb the rest of Vecna? It is your death you have found." And the lich stands up and we roll initiative. Let me roll with this guy. Okie dokie. I rolled a 12.
Oh, initiative. Yeah, sorry.
I got everybody in here. So let's see here. We got Cypher with an 11. So I go after Cypher there. Morgween rolls a 20. Rutherford, what'd you roll for initiative? A 5. And then Kai, you're rolling like crazy. I'm just going to count the first roll of 13. So I think you go ahead of Cypher like this. Right. And I rolled a 12. So you actually go ahead of Vecna. Morgween is up first.
I am going to cast Fairy Fire on Vecna. Give me a dexterity save, please.
I rolled a 14. So I fail, right?
You do fail. The DC is 16.
He has Fairy Fire on him, which means that you get advantage to attacking him, correct? And he cannot go invisible.
Correct.
What else do you want to do, Morgween?
I'm going to move down the steps to here, and that will be the end of my turn.
One thing, let's go back real quick, Morgween. Hit the letter M, and then hit the number 4. And then what that will do is, now move your, when you move your model, try to move your model again.
Doesn't look like it's allowing me to do anything.
So there you go. See, I'm like, when I move your model, you see it counts.
Yeah.
It uses the measuring stick.
Yeah, I get it.
Cool. Copy that. Let's rename him to Kai. Kai is up.
I'm up.
Yes. Vecna on deck.
Okay. Since I can't really do much, I'm just going to jab in with my spear.
You walk up with the ballista spear, you're butt naked. What's your AC at?
I think 14. Yeah, 14.
Okay, roll it up. Roll to hit.
8.
And our movement is half, too.
Yes, if you're, because you're swimming. That's correct. That does not hit.
Even with advantage?
He's hitting with advantage. That's correct. Roll with advantage. So roll one more time. So how you roll to attack with advantage or disadvantage, you right-click the button in D&D Beyond, roll damage.
Kai, 26.
You're rolling with a non-magical weapon, though. Right?
Yeah.
Liches are immune to all non-magical damage.
Oh, well, there's no point in me rolling damage then, is there?
Yes, I reveal it as you stick your spear into him. It sticks right into his ribcage. You don't know, maybe you hit him. Vecna's up. Vecna casts Fireball on everybody in here. Or no, he'll actually cast Lightning Bolt. Everybody rolls a dex save. DC 18.
Okay.
Alright.
5.
You fail.
What's the effect?
He shoots electricity up there. The electricity being underwater connects and zaps everybody. DC 18. Who failed?
I did.
27 damage for any of you succeed. You take half. If you have evasion, if you have evasion, you take 0 damage. Beckness' turn is over. Cypher's up.
Alrighty. So I'll move forward 5. 10.
I didn't know if you got evasion or not.
Do you have evasion, Kai, as being a barbarian?
No.
I don't know. I think barbarians do get evasion somewhere along the way. You also get danger sense, so you get advantage on dex saves.
Oh. Can I use my reaction to do absorb elements?
Yes.
I forgot about that.
That's a first level spell slot, or is that a cantrip?
Yeah, it's a first level spell slot.
Okay, roll it up, and you reduce the damage when you take the roll. You also store that energy, and I think if you use it by the end of the turn, you can do lightning damage. Cypher, what do you want to do? You move up to Vecna. It's underwater. It's kind of difficult to see. There's a skeleton with a crown a golden crown on his head, on a who is laying on a golden couch.
I'll fire my crossbow. I'm guessing it would have like disadvantage when it goes through underwater.
Yeah, sure. Well, I kind of just make it easy. Like, we're not using the underwater rules. You can just roll as is. Okay. So we'll say you move at half speed if we're in combat, though. Sure.
Is fairy fire permanent with advantage until like he gets rid of it? Oh, yeah. Okay, awesome.
So it requires concentration.
Alrighty. So first, my crossbow.
That's a pretty powerful single target spell.
Plus 10. That's 24.
Yep.
And it's magical. So it's 12 damage, max damage.
Nice.
And then my rapier attack. 11.
Does not hit.
Alrighty. And that's it. Can't move anymore.
Rutherford's up.
Bonus action. I'll start blade singing.
Okay.
Oh, and I took 14 damage, so I need to do a DC 10 constitution throw.
Yep. If you have Warcaster, you roll with advantage.
I don't. The dancing lights are gone.
No, they're still up. You roll a 17. The DC was 10.
I got a 6.
I saw you roll Morgwine. Oh, I'm sorry, Morgwine rolled. Yes, the dancing lights are now gone.
That was for my concentration for the fairy fire to stay up.
Cool.
I'm going to use my action to recast dancing lights.
Okay, wait. So you can see around again. The dancing lights go down and they reflame back up. The room gets re-illuminated. What else do you want to do?
And I already used my bonus action to play some.
I'm sorry about this, but I forgot I had advantage. So can I attack with my rapier again?
Yes.
Okay. Nope.
Natural one. Describe how you utterly fail fighting Vecna the Archlich underwater.
I try to pierce him, but I stab at the tip of the spear that went through him, so it didn't do anything.
Morgwine is up.
Okay. Would I have known that when Kai struck Vecna, that the damage would not have gone through?
And a powerful adventurer like yourself, this is common knowledge. That very right. Powerful greater undead.
Right.
But actually, Morgwine kind of questions something. Looks, something's wrong, Morgwine. You did damage him somehow. Your turn is up. What do you want to do?
Okay. I am going to... That's a reaction. All right, so I'm going to move down. Does that... No, it doesn't.
You just move at half speed.
Right, so every time I have to hit N and Ford to be able to get that...
What do you mean? You don't. It's a permanent thing. You can move down You can move down to the bottom of the steps. Do you want to get in a melee range with Vecna?
I do.
Yeah, I'll just move you right next to Vecna. There you can hit him like that, right?
Okay, yep. I am going to turn the flame on my flame touch longsword in my right hand. I've got the dancing short sword in my left. And here comes my first strike.
Here comes the pain!
The Flame Touch Longsword is my hex weapon, just so we're all aware.
Cool.
although I do not hit with an 11 with it.
You guys are rolling like shit.
Right? Here comes my...
Fairy Fire?
Advantage.
Advantage, right. So we'll consider this the second roll of the advantage, which...
Terrible.
Oh, wow. Random number generator is not loving me today. All right, so attack one misses. Here comes attack two with advantage this time. Oh, jeez, we're not,
you rolled a 14, right?
Yeah, 14.
Like, Morgwine, you're slicing into Vecna underwater as he's, like, trying, the Lich is trying to block your attacks as best as possible. Your second attack hits.
Oh, good. All right, so, let's get it going.
Roll damage.
There you go.
Wow. So
one-handed 16.
So yeah, you roll 6 damage from the flame tongue. I'm sorry, 7 damage. Right. And then are you using two-handed? I see what you're doing there. Using it as one-handed or a two-handed weapon?
I'm using it as one-handed.
So it's 9 plus 7, correct?
16? Right, correct.
Got it.
Yep. I'm going to bonus action strike with the dancing short sword from my left hand.
Oh, you're dual wielding?
Yep.
You hit 14 again.
Hits, yeah.
You slash all into right. him. The flames kind of erupt and then are quenched by the water underwater here. 8. Right.
So 8 points from the dancing short sword.
Nice. And that is bloodied.
Ooh, nice. That will be the end of my return. Oh, you know what? Hang on. I'm going to use a defensive flourish. I'm going to use a use of bardic inspiration to defensive flourish.
Okay.
I will deal extra damage to the target, the number on the roll I die, and add that to my AC. So at level 10, it's a die 8 still. So I'm going to roll a die 8. Which is a 1. All right. So one more point of damage to Vecna, and my AC increases to 20.
Cool. Kai is up.
Just made it back in time.
Yep. You want to attack with your spear? Kai, you look as you pull your spear out. You know you're not supposed to damage a lich. Something is wrong. You pull it out. You've done some damage to this creature.
I would like to grapple its skeleton head.
Want to grapple the skeleton head? So roll an athletics roll. I rolled a 20, so you have to beat a 20.
Come on, nah.
So it's your athletics. You're not raging, so you don't get advantage. I beat 16. You, so you're one of your attack misses as Vecna resists your grapple attack.
Can I try that again as a bonus action?
Do you have two attacks as your character?
Sorry.
You can do it one more time. I roll a 22. As you do your, so anytime you want to replace an attack with a grapple action, you can. Roll another athletics check, please. You do not roll with advantage for fairy fire. It's just for skill checks. You fail once again. This creature, Vecna, is very powerful. Vecna's up again. He says, "You all do not belong here." He begins to cast a spell. Does anyone try to counterspell him?
Yeah.
Roll an arcana roll. So how it works, what I do for this, so we remove the metagaming, is a free roll when he begins to cast a spell, you roll an arcana roll. If you roll higher, which is 10 plus the spell level, you can identify the spell being cast. As similar gestures and incantations, you know. Or at least can catch in the moment.
What is the spell?
Cloud Kill. So it's DC 15.
Can I look up that spell real quick?
It's nasty.
I'll take your word for it.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll cast Counterspell on
it. It's like 10 die 6 or something.
So how do we want to use the Zen Counterspell rules, or do we want to do rules just written Counterspell rules?
I don't know either very well.
So we'll use the Zen one. Roll your spell attack modifier.
Yeah, the regular one is if you do a higher spell than the one he has, it automatically fails.
Roll a d20, and then add your spell attack mod. So your plus hit to spell is what?
Plus 7. Or no, plus 8.
Plus 8? You successfully plus 8? So I rolled a 10. I rolled a dirty 10. And then it's plus the difference of the spell. So plus 2. You successfully counterspelled Vecna. Cypher is up.
Am I able to go over to the opposite of him and try to hide behind the couch?
You want to use hide as your action or bonus action?
Bonus action.
Yes. I roll against his perception to hide, so roll a stealth roll.
15.
Roll a natural. I roll a 2.
Okay.
So, so now you're hidden. As you kind of like lurk, you like swim underwater behind the couch a little bit. you like blend into the shadows. He looks around to see where you're at. You're gone.
And then I'll kind of like swim over quickly over the wall and stab him with my rapier.
Okay. So how it works is you roll with advantage, plus fairy fire is up, correct?
Yep.
So you get to roll with how we do advantage stacking is we add plus two to the roll. So you have a 22.
Oh, my bad. 22.
Plus the flank, which is another plus two. So 24 in total. That's a hit.
So that's 1d8 plus 5 plus another d6.
Your sneak attack damage does count if you have it.
Yeah, so that's additional d6.
You just have one level of rogue or whatever?
No, actually, that's a good point. I've never played rogue, so I don't know how much
you should have. Like, how much? What level rogue are you? 10th level?
Yeah, 10th level.
You should have like 66 sneak attack.
So 5d6.
Yeah. Oof. Roll another 5. So, roll it again. Roll 5d6 damage.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that. Oh, just roll again? Okay.
Yeah, just roll it again. Make it simple. You rolled like shit.
Yeah, thanks for that. Hey, no additional 10 damage.
Is that your only attack?
Yeah, since I use my bonus action to hide, I can't use my other weapon, so that'll be it.
So what we've done with two-weapon fighting is we've buffed the shit out of it, because two-weapon fighting is just underpowered. So how I do it, if you wield two weapons, you attack with your main hand, and your offhand is considered a free action. Cause no action, no bonus action, nothing.
Yeah.
Also because...
And that means I can fire because my crossbow, I get to, with a crossbow feat, I automatically get to free reload.
Roll an attack, yeah.
Awesome.
Because it makes sense because you compare it to like two-handed weapons. That way also it frees up your bonus action.
27.
Roll damage. As Vecna approaches death door.
12 damage.
You will not escape. The room begins to shake. Rutherford is up.
All right, I got 20 feet of movement. And I'm gonna just attack him with my rapier with blade singing. That's probably a miss.
It hits.
And, oh. 12 damage.
How do you kill Vecna the Archlich?
As I come up to him with my blade singing, I take my rapier and stab him right in the face.
As you stab him, the room begins to collapse. 10.
Oh, shit.
9.
I'll quickly grab the 8. Staff and begin to swim up.
You grab his mace out of his hand. He doesn't have a staff. It's just the model does.
Okay, mace. Yeah.
You grab the mace.
I grab Ragnar himself and I pull him up with me.
You grab who? Morgwine?
No. Vecna? Is it the guy in the floor that's dead?
He wants to take his body.
Oh, Vecna? You want to take Vecna's body? You grab Vecna's body you grab him up and you pull him up. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. The whole room behind you, you look back, caves in. So how was it, guys? Did you guys have fun beating Vecna?
I don't think that was Vecna.
No. That was too easy.
Too easy.
Kai,
you have the body of Vecna in your hands.
Okay.
With his mace, right?
Yeah.
You look back, the room is totally collapsed.
It looks totally fine to me.
What do you guys do?
I'll like point back to go up, like all the way back up to the surface so we can talk a bit.
I'm assuming you guys can just talk underwater with the water breathing spell.
Yeah, I don't think that was Vecna. Yeah. I mean, I haven't met a lich before, but from what I've heard about them, it shouldn't have been that easy.
Yeah, I don't think it was even. I think it was a little weak.
Yeah. I feel like that was a false one, especially when we passed through a secret secret door earlier down here.
Yeah.
You pull off the body. He's wearing a very valuable crown. The crown, Morgwine, you've never... It's like something a king would wear. You've seen and you've dealt with kings in the past, perhaps as entertaining. The crown is worth 25,000 gold, and the couch that you saw downstairs was inlaid with gold. It must be very valuable as well. Too bad the room collapsed.
Yeah, not getting that. So do we want to make our way out of the area? Back to where?
Yeah. Can I also, like, with my expertise, I'm kind of see if there's anything magical about this maze?
Go on, Arcana roll.
I was going to do a detect magic or Arcana, whatever, once we got out of the water. But if you want to do it here, it's cool.
Yeah, I got 15.
Definitely magical of some kind. You see runes on it, and it has skulls and so forth. You kind of know, though, it's like a mace of binding, though. It's the best way to describe it, like binding magic. Not properly identifying it, it's unknown, its full properties.
I look at Morgan, like we could identify this later, but I think it might be best to give this to Kai.
Sure, I don't think I'll be wielding it.
Yeah, well, it'd be a lot more useful with him actually having a proper weapon, especially when a spear that shouldn't be damaging a lich apparently did.
Can I investigate its body, see if there's like a key on it?
You search the body of Vecna. People can roll a history roll if they wish to, if they're proficient in history. Morgwine rolls a natural 20. Morgwine, like, you've read the tales of the Archlich. And Kai, of course, rolls a 5. Kai is picking his nose, wondering where his clothes are at and why his loot wasn't in this chamber.
Pretty sure he's proficient as well.
Yeah, it sucks. Morgwine, you've heard about Vecna. And you've heard about tales of the Tome of Vile Darkness. And you check the body for it, as the Archlich apparently has this artifact in his possession. You do not see the Tome of Vile Darkness. Your hunch is correct. This cannot possibly be Vecna, but it's a well-made forgery of it. It's wearing an extremely valuable crown, a crown meant for a king, someone who had opulent wealth. Definitely built this type of trap, or at least wanted to convince others that Vecna was dead, if they so slayed him. Morgwine makes an insight roll. The DC is 20. He passes. Morgwine, you go back, you're just like, something's not adding up. You go back and look back at the room where you just came out of. The room is set back into place. The collapsed room is no longer there. Must have been a programmed illusion. You're muted, by the way.
Do I see... without going into the room, do I see Vecna there?
Make a perception roll. 27.
Random number generator likes me today.
Whatever this creature was, is not in there anymore. The room appears to be empty.
I'm going to cast Detect Magic and look down into the room.
Quick question.
Sorry, go ahead.
I did pull Venka's body out of that room, right?
You do. Yes, his body's out.
So I still want to take that with us.
You have him slung over your shoulder.
Pretty much, yeah.
So I'll move his body with you. Well, I'm just putting him like this, and I describe what's happened. I delete Vecna's body, or Vecna's body, for now. You guys getting the feeling for this dungeon yet?
It's fun. Yeah. I'm getting that feeling.
What do you guys
do? I see anything magical in the room that has been recreated?
You look at the mace that was this creature was having. That is magical. The crown is not magical. Nothing else is magical. But you look down into the room, and you do see don't see anything that's magical in the room.
Okay. And I know that Kai took the mace, or the mace was recovered from the room the last time we were here.
It would need to be identified to understand its full properties.
Right.
Does anybody want to identify the mace?
I'll ritual cast it later.
Okay.
Alright, so I will go back where everybody else is, get out of the water.
Well, hold on now. Surely they did not want us to be in that room for a reason, don't you think?
Oh. It might have just been the ruse to kill us. Sent us off the track.
Perhaps. But why waste effort of making an illusion of a collapsing room after its guard has been perished?
That's a fair statement.
I believe we should go take another look, see what else we can find in that room.
Yes, I'll go back and...
Rutherford goes back down in the room and looks around with the rest of you guys. So Rutherford's like, let's take a second look at this room here. You find a small jade coffer. It contains some potions. The coffer itself is very valuable. Like, obviously this room was supposed to give the appearance of opulence, like something an immortal lich would sit in. Morgleen, you've seen fine furniture in royal palaces and hallways. This couch must be worth 50,000 gold. But if it was moved at all, if you tried to move it and you just bumped it into something, it would probably lose a lot of its value. It's like something you'd see in a museum. You also find a small sack. It holds 278 platinum pieces and 29 gems worth 10 gold pieces each. There's also 7 spell scrolls. They're mixed with first and second level spells. And there's appears to be a treasure map. Morgween makes a history roll on the treasure map. As his tales of being a bard travel far and wide, to discern the map's intention. The map shows 100 miles from this place. Roll a history roll, Morgween, on the map. Unfortunately, not high enough. There is 6 potions in the jade coffer. What do you guys do?
I'd like to collect the potions.
You collect the potions. They're unknown what they are. They would need to be identified or use alchemy against them.
Yes, I'll start grabbing the spells and handing off to either Morgan or Rusford.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say there's 7 spell scrolls. They're first or second level spells. You can decide what they are as a player.
I'll defer to Rutherford on that. Here, you figure out what you want. If there's anything you don't want, I'll take.
Yeah, or maybe you think you might be useful for any of us, just hand it over.
Let me open the index of spells. While I'm doing that, I kind of expected there to be a key in here. According to the riddle.
Oh, sorry.
You look high and low through the room, the rest of the room, Rutherford. You spend another 10 minutes. I'll end another 10 minutes to the timer as you do a thorough toss of the room. There's no key. I've described everything in the room.
I feel like we should continue through that other secret door right by the... right beneath the spikes. Besides the spikes. There's another way.
Very well.
that might have the key.
So I'm going to move. So I'm going to move. You're kind of talking about secret doors, so I made a mistake. Of course, I did a classic DM mistake. There was a secret door right in front of you in the pit. But as you walk by this area, you're like kind of, Cypher, you're like, there's a secret door here. And being an expert thief, it's easy to spot sometimes, or maybe not something. You spot another secret door to the right here, connected here. But you look at it, there's a seam of a door here. There's no keyhole. What do you do?
I'll try to swim and push it forward.
Marguin, I added 10 minutes to the timer for searching. That's as long as your detect magic works, correct? Is 10 minutes?
Correct.
So your detect magic has gone down.
Okay.
The potions, by the way, were magical. The 6 potions that Rutherford has gathered.
Yeah.
From the room.
But I will push the door if I can.
You push on the door. No effect. This door is much more well hidden, Cypher. Only it was meant to be hidden.
Can I attempt to push the door up rather than forward?
You go down, you like lean underwater, you brace your feet in the cold water. Your body is adapted to it, kind of like jumping into the Arctic, you know? By now, your whole body is numb. You pull up with all your strength. You stop. You don't want to give yourself a hernia.
Can I... I wonder if this door is magical. Is there any way that we can push this with magical means?
I can do that.
Well, let's see if that can give it a try.
Are we certain it requires it, though?
I'm a little
cheap with the spell slots.
Can I detect if this is a magical door or it's just a really tough door?
Like, there's no runes or inscription on it. You would have to start casting magic to really do something.
Yeah,
it's a very well hidden door. Someone did want it to be found.
Yeah, I think it's not magical, but it's definitely well hidden. Doesn't want to be budged. Somebody's definitely trying to hide something.
Why don't we try normal means first, and if they fail, then I'll hit them up with a knock spell.
I guess what I can try to do, we can use the spear that Kai had, and I'll use one of my daggers and see if we can try to use means of like almost like crowbarring it like open.
You try to like crowbar it open with using the spear, right?
Yeah.
Roll a d20 with the spear as you try to wedge it in between just a small little sliver or a crack. It was almost like the ballista snaps and breaks. Remove the ballista from your sheet, Kai.
Hey, you got the mace.
You do have a mace. Yeah. It's a one-handed mace, right?
One-handed. Okay.
The mace is magical. There is magic on the mace, but it's unsure what it does.
So it's just a standard one-handed mace for now?
Yes.
When I see that the ballista breaks and then everybody's sort of scratching their heads looking around, I'll just knock it.
Cast a knock on the door.
Open sesame.
Crack. A thunderous sound traverses through the underwater passageway. You guys all kind of have to cover your ears and brace for the impact. The sound travels through water much more quickly. The door trembles. And I reveal the next area.
Is there a way to snap to your character? I seem to
top left. The,
yeah.
You see your little character, you can click on it and it'll snap to it.
Ah, thank you so much.
No problem.
I remove the secret door. Like that. It comes up to another door. Let me see if I reveal it again. So you guys continue to walk down the hallway. It comes up to another set of doors. You guys like how I'm doing this? With the hidden zones?
Yeah, I think it's pretty cool.
There's another doorway here. What do you guys do?
Is it same as the last?
In anger of losing the spear, I would like to charge at the door.
You charge at the door? Do we let him charge to the door, guys?
Yes. Go for it, buddy. I kind
of like so run up. Yeah, you get the rest of the group kind of braces as you angrily, Kai, in a fit of rage, yells and swims as fast as he can through the door and braces his shoulder in there like a little dolphin or something, right, guys? Right click the door and hit open door. The door opens with ease. No trap is set off. I'll reveal the next room. And I'll tell you about it. 1 second.
I actually didn't find my character. It doesn't seem to want to snap to me.
Oh, okay, sorry, Morgween. Did I delete you? Yeah, so what I have to... what happened to Morgween is I messed up.
Okay. I thought it was me. I'm like, what the hell did I do?
No, you're fine. This map is also just really complex. What I need to do is make your model unique. So here we go, Morgween. Boom. And then I'll make your model unique like this. I got to take your old model and ununique him.
Oh, I get it. Yep. Cool.
And I'm going to delete this guy. There you go. So now you're there. Yep, you step into, lack of a better word, words, is like a mummy preparation room. There are like vats. There's three vats here, guys. You see they're marked in blue. We're right below the surface of the water, so the movement of the cameras and stuff is a little tricky. But there's three vats. You see mummies, a mummification process happening. So definitely someone with necromancy skill is creating mummies here. Or at least they were. What do you guys do? All the walls are lined with shelves. They're old jars filled with dust and important ingredients of all sorts. There's a large desk and stool with two workbenches and two mummy preparation tables. Clay pots and urns on these tables on the floor obviously once contained ointments, oils, perfumes, and the like. Linen, wrapping, and the rolls are strewn about. Dried herbs of unidentifiable nature, bones, skulls, and the littered workbenches. What do you guys do?
I missed it. What's in this room?
Did you phase out during my narration?
My brain did, yeah.
Typical. I know. This is a very challenging dungeon. Just like descriptively, it's like kind of weird. This is a mummy preparation room. There's two mummy bodies and three vats. The vats are 7 feet in diameter and 4 feet in depth. Contain murky liquids. They seem to be submerged under the water. So in other words, the buoyancy of the liquid is denser than the water table, us being below the water table at this point. And whoever has a proficiency in nature can make a nature roll.
I'll also go, I'll walk up to one of the mummies and just stab it, just in case if it might be up to something.
Stab it? It just like flickers a little bit under the water. No effect.
Doesn't seem like they finished these.
The room, of course, leaves at the other end, and I'll reveal that. as well. I can here.
Is it possible if I could use one of the scrolls?
Which scroll do you want to use?
It said it put two dark vision, but I was wondering if we could change it to one to a locate object.
You want to change it to locate object?
Yeah.
What are you trying to locate?
My gear.
Awesome, I like that idea. That idea, guys. Are you proficient? You're not proficient in casting. So how scrolls work is you actually have to be able to cast that particular spell within your class. And I don't believe you can. But Morgwen could, or Rutherford could, I believe. Because they're both wizards.
I didn't know a scroll needed to proficiency of the class. So I don't know if all those spells can be used.
Yes, you can. You can cast it, Rutherford.
Well, I know about that one, but the other six spells I chose, I didn't pay attention to the class.
I was actually wondering, wouldn't it work if I explained the item to him and then have him cast the finger?
That's correct. What do they look like, Kai?
The
family heirloom.
It looks like a big adamantium axe, two blades, one on either side, like a battle axe. Since I can only specify one item, I can't do all.
I think it has to be within 100 feet, though, correct? What's the range in that spell? It's 1,000?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It gives you a generalized direction, right? But it doesn't tell you exactly where it is.
No, it just gives you the general idea.
Yes, it's a sphere of 1,000. I'm going to say, I don't want to map it out. We could map it to scale, but again, I have a shit ton of hidden zones. Rutherford?
Instead of mapping it out, I came up with the idea in my game that you could use hot or cold the closer as we get to it. I know that makes things a little bit different.
I'm just reading through the spell. That you feel, Rutherford, you sense it. I would say you're lukewarm. You're not ultra close. Like with it, when you're in 30 feet of the object, you'll know if it's around, right?
So I would definitely want more.
I like that rule, Kai.
Because I'm keeping the dancing lights up. That's a concentration spell.
Yes.
That's if Morgwen's okay with that. Because if not, then I can.
Someone needs to reduce the locate object spell. Then the spell scroll, right? That they used it. Right. So you're down to what is it? Five scrolls now. What are the five scrolls that you used? Just put them in Discord if you want.
I already did.
Okay, cool.
That's the ones I think I want. I mean, I propose there's a list. Anybody can suggest another different spell for
me. Okay. We're going to move off in Thrall then, right? And say we replace that with Locate Object, correct?
I was going to replace one of the Dark Visions with it.
Okay, let's do that. Go back and edit the post then. Cool. Rutherford, though, you do get some good information. The gear is nearby. It's within 1,000 feet. Yeah. So it's not like it's just like gone like permanently away. It's close. There is hope that our naked barbarian will once again recoup his gear.
Is it in motion, the object, or just sitting?
You sit there for a minute before reactivating the dancing lights. The change, the sensation of the object, like again, the hot and cold feeling, the temperature doesn't change. It's not moving.
I'll look at the main desk that's here for the necromancy chamber.
You spend like a few minutes. I'll add like 5 minutes to the timer as you spend some time like looking through it, right? It's just like evil ass necromancy stuff, man. Like mummy wrappings. It's not easy to make a mummy. Someone takes a dead body, wraps it, and raises it. You know, and then it's like in their command and control. Cypher, you worry there might be a mummy or mummies and further in the dungeon. Right?
I'll just begin to move forward.
Okay. And there's like three glowing vats, right? You guys see these vats here?
Yes.
Do you move to the next room? Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, well, it seemed like somehow my character magically teleported up.
Teleportation is evil. I mean, I guess. Let me see what we can do here. I just want to point out that Cypher, you're the only person who didn't make a model.
Wow, thank you.
I'm moving back into the room.
So,
I'll try to use the arrow keys if you have problems using this three-dimensional map. Right? That's how I kind of, when I'm moving around these super complex maps like this, especially like we're underwater, you know, going downstairs, I just use my arrow keys.
Yeah, I use a mixture between arrow keys and teleport,
or shift
and left click.
Yeah, shifting too.
Yeah.
So you're moving into the next room then, right, correct, Cypher? Are we moving out of this room?
Yeah, I was moving to the next room.
Before I did that, I wanted to like do all six directions of that spell to see if I can tell what direction the object is.
Oh.
You want to try to like geolocate it a little bit more?
Yeah.
By walking around before you recast it. Before you recast Dancing Lights. It appears to be east to slightly northeast and down.
Which way is north, northeast and down.
So if I'm looking at your model, let's find your model here, and I'll tell you exactly. Like where you're facing right now, where your model is facing, that's kind of where it is, but it's down.
Can you give me like an approximate angle down?
I think that might be a bit difficult for him.
Okay.
Tail spire is a bit.
Is it like 45 degrees or maybe like 30? Like one room down or two rooms down?
Give me a second.
Oh crap, my speaker just died.
That's all the information I can give you.
All right. I think I got an updated list that's more effective.
Okay. What do you guys do?
I'm just beginning to push down the staircase.
I recast Dancing Lights and fall after Cypher.
Okay, let me double click Cypher here.
How are we doing on time for the breathe underwater?
It lasts for one day, 24 hours.
Oh, okay. Cool. All right.
Yeah, it just kind of helps you guys out so we don't get, you know, hamstrung because now everybody picked a sea creature or a lizard man or whatever.
I had enough potions, but...
Hey, you'll find them here soon enough.
Cypher leads the way. Let us make a roll of Cypher. 1 second. Cypher, you notice a pit trap again. Right in front of you. Let me reveal it.
Not very effective in water.
Or maybe it's like there's air underneath, like sucks you up.
As you, and it looks like the person actually, so what's, the pit trap is there. You kind of kick it open and a ton of snakes just like start to pull out and swim out. They seem to like ignore you though for now. As you kind of stand still for a second, the snakes like slither by everybody, freed from whatever hell they were maybe in there. You look down and you see small holes, snakes, like Indiana fucking Jones, man.
Why'd it have to be snakes?
The pit is actually, let me take a look here, 1 second. Let me go back to my map. You just swim across it. Cool. If you want to try to disarm one of these traps too, I'll tell you if there's a trap there, Cypher. And if it needs to be disarmed, we'll make some rolls. Some sleight of hand rolls, okay?
Okay.
Let me reveal the next room, I guess. Cool. You look to your left, Cypher, as you're kind of like, you're taking your time, you know, going down the hallways here, and you see like a dead end, and you're like, no fucking way. And you look to your left, you see another secret door.
Yeah, not much of a secret if you constantly do it everywhere.
I make a roll. I roll in a secret every time, by the way, to see if we do it. I remove the door like that, and let's put out the model. Give me 1 second.
Oops.
Into the void he went.
There we go. There appears to be a doorway in front of you. What do you guys do?
I mean, if it's something wrong with it, I'll try to push it open.
You push it open, right click and hit open. I'll describe the room here. It's an agitated chamber. The room appears to be filled with furniture, offerings, and furniture. Funerary, that's the way they describe it. So it's like urns of like, you know, like something where you would be burnt to ashes and put in, right? There are 4 rotting sofas, a couple of throne-like chairs, and a jumble of stands, small tables and vases and urns that are dented, chipped, and broken. Only rather plain tapestries hanging on the east and west walls appears to have been spared a rough looting. Amid the general havoc are several scattered trunks and a large number of coffers. And the room... Let me see if I can change. I must have messed up the hidden zone here.
No, I was going to say we're only seeing half a room here.
I'll try my best, guys.
Does the tapestry look anything similar?
There's a wall right here. You look at the tapestry. Let me take a look at what this is. Make a nature roll as you begin to look at the tapestry.
Oh, I was nearly a natural 20.
It feels pretty cold as you begin to... Do you want to rub your fingers through it?
Yeah.
It's like frigid cold.
Make it a lot more cold.
Make a con save. DC 12.
Con save, I get advantage on those.
Nice.
2 natural ones, let's go.
Your luck has run out. You hear the chuckle of Vecna in the caves. You take 26 cold damage.
Even with evasion?
Even with the... it's not a dex save, it's a con save.
Oh, yeah.
Great question. Someone with nature can roll, though. You try to rub it, it's very difficult. It's like moldy.
I'll take... and drink a potion of greater healing.
Roll it up.
Well, I thought you made it way for you to drink it.
Yeah, but Morgulene doesn't know our little house rules. So how we do it is if you want to roll, drink a potion as a bonus action, you make a straight roll, like as intended. As a full action, you get maximum from the potion.
Ooh.
I'm gonna make a... 1 second here. As you rub your fingers through it and you're like drinking, you're looking at this mold a little bit, Cypher. There's something there, like behind the mold. It would require further search, but it's kind of more difficult because fucking it's cold.
I'll grab my rapier and dagger and try not to use my hands and move the drape and kind of like lift it up in the water.
Lift up some, you start chopping around some of the mold off a little bit, scraping it with the dagger. We'll have you make 1 more con save.
Come on, man.
How about we make it with disadvantage?
Well, that means you'll be a flat roll.
Oh, no.
That's a flat roll then.
Yeah, because I mean, you're like chomping off the mold. It's a mold kind of gets on your gloves and your hands. A 1 and a 2, baby?
A 1. It's a 1.
3 natural ones.
You take another 20 cold damage, but you reveal another secret door.
All right, anybody want to heal me?
Oh my god.
I'm almost half.
Bloody.
How does everyone else look? Have we all taken some damage?
Yeah, especially with some people just took lightning damage too.
Yeah, I'm gonna do a mass cure wounds, which will be here. I'll post it.
You can roll it up, that's right?
One in 8,000 chance you just got right there.
Oh my god!
Wait, everyone healing by 23?
Correct.
Hell yeah! Woo!
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, try not to. That was my big boy spell, so not to do it again.
I messed up before. I got resistances to all damage. Oh shit! I just took that as damage.
The fuck?
What?
I'm trying to figure out where there's so many hidden zones in here, guys. This whole dungeon is like a massive amount of. It's better if I just delete the zones as we go through them, but I don't have to re-toggle them. That way it kind of cleans up the map a little bit.
Yeah. And multi-level like that kind of makes it even more confusing, I'm sure.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Yeah, it's behind the slime here. Cool. So I'm going to remove, this is the secret door. It's behind this mold slash tapestry here that the guy used. And there it is. There's a secret stairway that goes down. Do we continue?
Do I see this door in this corner?
I'm just looking at the combat roll. Morgween, how do you cast mass cure wounds on everyone?
Are you looking for like a semantic or,
yeah.
or how I'm doing it?
Yeah.
I stand in the center of everyone that they're kind of like around me. I can't play my instruments underwater, so I can't do it as like a, but I will sing.
I was gonna sing.
It reverberates a little bit. The water, like as you open your mouth, the water is like in your lungs, and it's like the strangest sensation of you breathing water in and out. Without drowning.
I'll take one of my tokens of the ghoul and I'll release his soul from it.
Okay, and do what?
I don't do anything. That will allow me to have one open slot.
Okay.
I don't have a limited amount. Unless anybody wants to ask a question before it goes.
What ghoul is this?
It's the ghoul that we killed upstairs.
We don't want to ask the ghoul a question? It was the gargoyle, saying, right?
Yeah, if anybody wants to ask it a question. The thing about it is, it's just like the... I forgot what spell it is, where you can ask it a question. It can still lie if it feels like it, but it tries to answer as consciously as it can.
And you can always make an insight roll to see if it's lying.
True. So...
Are we going to ask the gargoyle a question before the soul is released?
Yes.
What do you want to ask about this?
Where's my gear?
No.
It's already asked.
No, you have a spell that you're using, you selfish bastard. I'm going to punch him in the face.
Is this the way to Vecna?
Are we on the right path to Vecna?
Vecna created me long ago. And then I was taken by the cultists. They said they wanted to hide him from everyone. Though Vecna may never be found. The soul is then released.
Insight check.
Okay. I roll them both in secret.
21.
Yeah, I'm going to roll yours in secret so you don't
know. Evil.
Actually, so I'm rolling yours nice first. Villains. I'm going to roll mine. The soul appears to be telling the truth from the inflections of the voice. No stammering or stuttering. Unknown, maybe, what it was talking about.
What were cultists involved? Probably, I would guess people for necromancy, but what would they want the power of a lich for? Any ideas or any history from you guys knowing about something like this?
all from me.
Do you want me to roll for it, or you want to do it in secret as?
Roll a history roll if you want.
Copy that. 12.
Unknown.
Well, there's always crazy lunatics after the power of madmen, so it's not entirely surprising. But I guess we continue forward.
Do I see this door in the corner?
Or what door? Is
the door doesn't exist and it's just cosmetic?
Which door?
This one here.
You want to open it?
Yeah. But
of course you do.
I want to open it as if I'm hiding behind the door at the same time. So whatever comes flying out.
Oh yeah, whatever comes out, it comes for us.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think you're gonna have any loot by the end of this.
You try to touch the door. It's like slimy, green. Your hand begins to burn. Make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, a dexterity one.
They dodge out of the way. 17.
You have danger sense too, right? So you roll with advantage as a barbarian. Roll with advantage. Just trying to help you out with your class a little bit.
I just rolled it once or more. That's it. 19.
You pass. So you quickly jerk your hand back. What else do you do?
I think that's just another trap, Kai.
Yeah, but everywhere we've gone so far, it feels like it's a trap.
Well, just continue where it leads us.
As you said earlier, secret doors on secret doors. So it's feels like we should go for a different door this time.
I think that's one of the worst decisions you ever made. And I start continue going down.
Kai, what do you want to do, Kai? As the party says, we want to go this way.
Well, they can go that way. I'm going to try and stop this thing.
Yeah, you can go for it, man.
I want to wedge my dagger in between the door
Okay. And
the wall.
Some slime begins to come off. Roll another dex save.
19.
Do you have a dagger? I thought you have no equipment. Who gave you the dagger?
They gave me Morgan did?
I gave him a dagger last week.
Yeah.
The dagger begins to dissolve and it snaps. The acid has destroyed the dagger.
So I got one dagger left.
You have one dagger left and a loincloth.
And a mace.
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to follow them back behind.
Move your model.
Okay.
As the dungeon slowly whittles away every possession you have.
The spear, the dagger.
That dagger belonged to my grandfather. You bastard.
I mean, you did give it to him. He lost all his equipment. You kind of should have expected this to happen.
Yeah, it's my own fault.
Wait, the slime took away everything I own again?
No, the dungeon.
Just the dagger.
Oh.
You come down the hallway.
Another prosperous endeavor, Kai.
You are entertaining, at least.
Yeah. Oops, how did I get all the way up there?
So just to verify, I've got no gear again, right?
No, you've got
one. You have a dagger and a mace and a loincloth.
Okay. Oh, but yeah, I thought I lost all my
gear. No, thankfully it wasn't
the PTSD is setting in?
Just an acidic one.
Oh, Violet, what potions do we have?
You didn't identify him.
We didn't identify him.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Do we want to sit down for 10 minutes and identify him?
I mean, can I also, see if, any of them look like any common potions?
Are you proficient in alchemy?
I'm in expertise.
In alchemy?
Not alchemy, sorry, my bad. I thought you said arcana.
Alchemy.
So no. No.
Do you want to take a little sip, though, of it, maybe, and get a little taste on your mouth? And
maybe. Like how I did with the necrotic resistance?
Yeah, something like that.
I know. I feel like if they can identify it, so be it.
Oh, I'm proficient in alchemy.
Roll it up. Yeah.
What do I roll?
Roll nature roll. Yep. I like using the skills over, say, the tool set proficiency. Roll a 15. Pretty easy. You look, give a second look at this first. You spend like a minute just kind of like swishing it. You take some like other ingredients in the water and you quickly like try to stop it, you know, in there. And it begins to glow just as you thought, right? Potion of healing. They seem to be 6 potions of healing.
Oh, just but basic. One mystery potion?
No, all 6 of them are potions of healing.
Just basic ones too.
Basic potions, I guess. I have to look it up because the nomenclature of how they identify that's what's kind of confusing about D&D is like the nomenclature of stuff is like left over from other editions.
I'll take one for myself, and then the rest you guys
can see. I've changed it already in your D&D, so there's like I had the tier system to it. So there's minor, adept, master, and major healing potions. So I've standardized how that all that works. I'm gonna say these are adept healing potions. Which, if I use, let me look it up. Of course, you know I didn't put it in there, like a dumb dumb. they heal for 20 HP each.
Right.
44 plus 4. Because it was here for 2d4.
I'll take 2. Kai takes 2. And you guys take 1 each.
Add it to your sheets.
Smart.
That works for me.
That definitely works for me.
Alright.
So it's adepts is 20.
Yeah. Yeah. If anything, it would help you as potion of greater healing. That's the equivalent.
Oh,
okay. Greater healing?
Okay. Yeah, because that's, at 20.
Yeah. That's what I did.
Like, for instance, the master healing potion heals for 10d4. Which is like a supreme healing potion, right? But we just standardize all the names. But you're not like, what the fuck's that name? Helps out with the things like, so if you want to master summon something, it kind of breaks down some of the logic so there's not confusion across the naming.
I can't take 2 potions.
Why not?
I have nothing to store it in.
You can attach it to your loincloth.
Yeah, you can tie it up a bit.
Okay.
You try to tie it across your loincloth, Kai. You just like
make hint, a pouch out of it.
Not to get like X-rated, but you know, as you do that, like you see like the ball sack a little bit.
Actually, technically, I do have a backpack.
You lost all the materials, right?
No. But I'm using Venka on my back, so wouldn't that class it as a bit of a storage base?
He has no. Are you toting his corpse around still?
Yeah.
Okay. you can store the potion. You put it like in the, his like robe or whatever that he had. You can like slip it in there.
You cut it open.
About that.
You cut it open and you just store inside his innards.
All right, here we go.
I just try to like pull it out, and it's just like guts.
I've been rolling pretty good on your perception rolls, by the way. Until now.
Thank you.
Oh.
I roll a 2. Give me a second. Just as you feared, Cypher. A trap. The trap opens up and sucks you down. It just was waiting for the right amount of pressure. You get sucked down into the pit. Trap and the water falls on you. There's really no save. I'm gonna say it's 2d10. What? 2d6.
Can I say as a quick reaction? I pulled him back as he was being sucked in, since I was not far behind him.
Yeah, go ahead and roll a dex saving throw as a reaction. It's a 30-foot pit, and there's spikes down there. You see the spikes, Cypher, that you're on?
15.
Yikes.
I got a 15.
Oh, somehow you ended up on the bottom of the ocean. Not good. Oh, you know why? Because I think I have to reveal it. Give me a second.
Yeah, you didn't reveal it, yeah.
I know, I'm sneaky and I've hidden it all.
Seems more than like 30 foot jump.
See, like this? See, I did a reveal there. So that's cool. Like, what this guy has done with some of the traps is he's used the hidden zones to like hide it. So like that. But now there you are. See the spikes there?
Mm-hmm.
You roll a 15. I'm gonna say to actually catch him because you guys are kind of getting lazy. On the road, just like you guys are just taking shift for granted. I'm gonna do 2d6 damage.
I don't think
evil DM. So I've done that as far as falling on the spike. So you take 9 damage. Plus, it looks like it's 20 feet down. Another 2d6 of bludgeoning damage. 10 bludgeoning damage.
13.
So you take 10 plus 9 of piercing by falling on the spikes, and then the water pours onto you and like impales you a little bit more. And that was the trap.
Just for the roleplay side,
sure.
Wouldn't I get pulled in too since I was in attempt to grab him again?
No, you try to, but the vacuum pulls out and you like resist it. You roll still pretty high at a 15.
Okay.
Alrighty, I'll drink another potion of healing.
You look down at the end of the hallway, there's another door. And then there's another way this way where there's another door. And then you look down, there's another door down here.
Alrighty. So, I'll like...
You guys have come to a T-intersection.
Scoot up from the impaled spikes.
You swim up as the water just from the underground lake has come down.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like a black ichor blood.
Marguin, you look perplexed. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm just studying the map and the doors.
Cool. What do you guys do?
Do I know if he said it was northeast or not for my gear? I want to use locate object before.
Rutherford, yes.
Yeah, he said north, northeast. Okay. I don't. No offense, Kai, but I don't think your gear is top priority for now. secondary.
Yeah, I get that. I get
it. It's not like I would. It's not saying that I won't go out of the way to find it, but we're here for a reason.
I kind of feel like we keep going straight.
I'm kind of feeling that too, to be honest.
Yeah. I mean, I don't have much of a better idea. Left, right, center. I don't care which way we go. So if straight you want, straight we go.
We're going straight?
Yeah.
Yep.
Let me make a roll.
I do believe Kai's gear might actually be up to the north.
You make a thorough check of this door cipher. There's no traps or anything like that.
Alrighty.
Is this supposed to be a missing wall here?
You have to embrace it. What missing wall are you pointing at right here? Yeah.
Yeah, one more left.
Kai makes a really good, not Kai, but Cypher, you make a really good roll. There is a door. Let me take a look here. It's just the hidden zone fucked up. Okay. So what I'm going to say has happened is, I don't know why it is. Let me take a look. It's just a part of the hidden zone. It got clipped in there somehow. So yeah, the door opens. You check it thoroughly. There's no traps. And it leads up to... I'll reveal it on the map here. I'm going to just try to delete the hidden zones when I can. It makes my life just a lot easier, so I don't have to manipulate all these hidden zones. Actually, you're talking about this door right here. By the way, Rutherford?
The one before the door.
Yeah, this gap right here. Give me 1 second.
Yeah.
So it's just got clipped.
Is it just a wall?
It's just a wall for now.
Fake wall.
For now.
It's invisible.
If you watch DM Jacobs, he's like, door, not trap door. That's kind of how this dungeon is. It's like, it's so confusing. It confuses even the DM. You come up to like a cavern, okay? And... The cavern, let me describe it here. There's a thick silvery mist. It's shot with delicate shimmers of gold, partially blocks your view of the area that lies ahead. The area is considered to be heavy obscured. It appears to be a cavern of some kind. What do you guys do?
I'll start like gently go through and like kind of like stick onto the left side of the wall.
You're trying to, so here's, let me move you guys back a little bit. Let me kind of describe what it is. Before you're trying to like basically go around, what's happened is you see the outline of a cavern, but someone has, there's that kind of that silvery fucking mist thing we've seen with the doors before, guys. It's right in front of you.
When did we see the silvery mist?
Right as you kind of are you're looking right in front of you. I'm highlighting it with my flashlight. It's like 10 feet in front of your model.
Where do we see this from the past again?
In the gateways.
In the gateways, the doorways.
How Kai lost all his crap.
Same one or it looks different colored?
Make a perception roll.
Okay. 21.
Slightly different. Somehow. Different hues and tints to it. But you'd have to cast magic to determine, again, identifying it or something to really understand it more.
Do we want to leave this place for B? Or do we want to see what this does? We could see what the other story may late go ahead to. Or do we want Temp Fate again?
I'm curious to see what is in store for us in here.
Guy, you want to lead the charge but naked again?
I think he's AFK.
Oof.
I don't want to do without Kai taking the initiative here.
Yeah, so we want to take a look at the other doors first.
Yeah, let's go look at the other doors.
If anybody's going to Zerg ahead, we're going to let him do it.
So
I'll gladly take our fodder.
I'm going to try to say, like, I'm not going to try to be a dink about it, but there is doors here. You investigate him, though. There's very powerful magic. And I'm going to just say, like, you spend a minute or two. I'll add 10 minutes to the timer as you guys investigate it. They appear to be one-way doors that are only supposed to come this way, not that way. Right? So it's not like it's meant for you to go through them. I just don't want to reveal the room there. But there are doors. It's very well hidden. Go ahead.
We could probably go back to that intersection and turn to the right, or however you guys are orienting yourselves, to go right. And maybe that'll connect somehow with whatever is up in that neighborhood.
There's also a good possibility Kai's gear is this way.
Yeah, the direction we went to, the other one, are within this general direction. I wouldn't believe Kaisa would be in the middle of a seabed in the middle of a dungeon.
I'm back.
Okay, so do you want to go back and let Kai temp fate?
Do it. Sure.
Yeah.
Wait, I wasn't here. I didn't hear anything. What was going on?
Nothing for you to worry about, good friend.
Just go naked again.
But you might want to hand me that mace before you go through. And the dead body. Yeah.
Let's move the models up to here then, if that's what we're doing. If we're going to send Kai through.
The thing is, it's another misty door, but it's different this time.
As you see this guy, pale, stripped down to complete bare nothingness, as he goes in completely naked, and you guys are just going to allow this.
You've done it before.
Why not?
Oh, God.
You don't have dark vision, right?
I do not have dark vision.
All right, I'm gonna give him the scroll.
I like how now you question when the first time you said bust the wall, just go for it, and we try to tell you stop, but now we say go for it, and now you hesitate?
You see, if it's not his idea, it's no good.
I suppose if Kai is a bit of a coward, we can turn around and go the other way.
No. I'll do this. I'm doing this.
Very good, sir. I'm glad you've had a change of heart.
Rutherford rolls really high on his persuasion roll.
And this is where I walk through in sudden death. Instantly.
Yeah. Kai, do you walk through the silvery mist?
I'm guessing I've got dark vision now.
Do you have dark vision? You cast one of the scrolls, mark it from the sheet or whatever, that one of the... Yeah, we can just edit the list and...
We get separated, my dancing lights go away.
I'll be right by the shimmering door, though, just in case if anything happens.
So Kai is moving through the mist, correct?
I mean, I guess at the same time, I'll tie a rope around him.
Cool.
Yes.
Yeah, please do.
That's the poltergeist method.
Kai, you move up. I'll just describe it, because Kai's being a little bit more cautious now. He's not, like, just running through this thing. You're going to touch
I'm moving cautious.
You begin to, like, feel the mist in front of you in the water. It's very strange. Your fingers ripple through it. You listen closely. There's a sound of someone screaming from the other side. You guys hear you talking.
I hear this, and my instinct thought is to rush right in there.
Do you rush through?
Before he rushes through, I cast message on him to see if once he gets the other side, he can tell us where he is. Or if we should come through.
And at the same time, I'll try my best to ingrain myself to the ground and hold the rope just in case if I need to pull him back.
Like a bodybuilder's body, spectacular when nude and glistens within the mist.
He's naked.
Yes, he's butt naked. Ripped muscles. Only those achieved by the greatest cycles of testosterone.
Do we hear the sound of the screaming girl too, or just
there's no girl screaming. It's just the sound of someone screaming. And you run through the mist, guy. Make a saving throw. A DC 15 intelligence saving throw.
No! I've got minus one. This is bull. Oh, I got 20.
Natural 20.
You resist the magic. You have the rope tied around you. You resist it. You feel like your mind is about to slip and you push through. And you see you have no items on you. Nothing. Right? You see... I put the model out. Our carnivorous plant. Yeah. The carnivorous plant is like, oh, thank God you're here.
Oh, God.
Plant says.
Do we see that?
You guys can't see shit. You're on the other side, so this is between me and Kai.
How long I see him?
You can hear muffling if you get close to the mist. But beyond that, Morgwine has a message up, so I'm assuming they can talk back and forth. So Morgwine is relaying some of the information, but right now this is between me and Kai, unless you step through the mist.
I have a quick question. Is it speaking in common, or is it just speaking gibberish at this point?
Speaking in common to you.
Okay.
A talking fucking plant.
Thank God you made it through! I've been down here for so long! Why are you naked?
Why are you down here?
Who are you?
Seems a little trepid to give up his identity.
I'm just a naked passerby.
I haven't seen someone in over 2 decades.
2 decades? Damn. Try to approach slowly, as if I had my arms out in order to not scare it.
You walk closer to the carnivorous plant.
Oh, thank God! The rope is still attached to him, is it? Or did it, go limp as soon as
The rope is still, taut. Like, you feel it, on the other end.
Yeah, so I feel him getting closer. He's moving still.
I'm going to give you guys a benefit of that. You've figured out a way to say, hey, are you safe? And you, tug it, twice. Does Kai, return the tug to say he's safe? And he has message up between Morgan, so then... They're relaying information, I'm assuming, in a way.
I was just making sure it didn't disappear as soon as he walked in.
It's still taught. Yeah. It has not disappeared.
Yeah. The thing about message is the duration's only one round. So okay. if I can't recast it, which I...
Because you cannot see him. You can't see the target.
It'll be out of range, so it won't matter.
Well, you have to be able to see the target, and he's considered heavily obscured through that mist.
Mm-hmm.
So, realizing that...
God!
Do we want to go through? It doesn't seem like equipment disappears.
I message back and say, I wouldn't come through yet. I don't think it's very safe.
Don't go through that mist. It's cursed by Vecna.
He just said it's cursed.
Yep, we can't hear you anymore. You're now talking to yourself.
Oh.
Well, he doesn't realize that.
Oh. I'm going to say, so he's just, this is just between me and Kai.
Can I help you with anything?
Can you free me? My name is Bing Bong.
Anyone want to follow soon, or just let him adventure until he comes back?
Cypher, this is just between me and Kai.
No, I know. I was just saying that, just if anybody wants to go. Not trying to meta it.
Yeah, just give me, Kai, what do you do?
My name is Bing Bong. And I want to get out of here.
Hi, Bing Bong. How come you're trapped in here?
Do you want to know the truth?
Yeah, I want to know. As Kai goes to sit down.
The leaves, kind of flump. Is he kind of the head of the creature kind of flumps down in disappointment?
Vecna. He cursed me as a cruel joke. Kept me down here. He changed my beautiful elven body and he tormented me here. He said I didn't need to eat or sleep anymore. But I haven't seen him in a long time. And then those cultists came and they said that they sealed us away here. I say we because, you gotta have imaginary friends when you're down here so long. You get lonely.
Kai goes and looks around the room and does he see anything else in the room?
These are my friends. Pete, Peter, Paul.
He starts naming off all these plants that he's made friends with.
Robert, Rudolph, Baron, Sam.
He starts just naming off.
He says, do you have friends? My name's Bing Bong.
I'll rename him to Bing Bong.
Bing Bong, yeah, I have a few friends. I don't think you'll be able to get out of here through the smoke. I don't know how to set you free, but are you able not to walk through it, or is it a barrier for you?
I can't walk through it, and I just have this type of junk,
he points over to a bag. He's like,
I can't use it anymore because I'm not human. Or elven.
Do you mind if I have a look through it?
Go ahead.
It's like a bag. It contains... I'll roll it, I guess, if you want me to.
Yeah, you roll it. I don't mind.
Here we go. Hopefully it doesn't bust. 34 gems. The gems are worth 100 gold each. I'll put it in our Discord chat.
So just gems, nothing else?
One second. And a pair of bracers.
He says, those are my old bracers. Bing bong.
He like puts out his little flip, you know, like his leafy hands, and he's like,
but I can't wear them anymore. Do you want him? Can you be my new friend?
Let's go back to the other group. What is Morgween? And you feel the rope like tugging around, so he's moving in there. Cypher, it seems to be okay. What'd he do?
It seems like he's doing fine. It's moving slowly, not panicking. I don't know if you guys want to go through, just let him be. I feel like he might be dumb enough to charge, but I feel like he's smart enough not to get himself killed.
Yeah, perhaps we just wait a little longer, let him do his thing.
I agree.
I guess we give him this one chance of trust.
Rutherford, this place is like, it's not hell on Earth because you can't light your cigar underwater.
I know. I haven't had my cigar in my mouth for a while here.
You could do like a shape wire, just like get a few puffs.
Do we want to go back to Kai? You guys want to do anything as you're waiting outside the mist?
You can go back.
He says, "Do you take the bracers?"
If you will want me to take the bracers, I'll take them.
He waddles over to you. You know, it's like roots kind of like sometimes tendril into the ground a little bit. He says,
"Yeah, you can take them."
They're plus two bracers of defense, or bracers of defense. You put them on, they have like elven runes, elven inscriptions on them.
Bing Bong needs a new friend. Do you want to stay with Bing Bong?
I would love to stay with you, but maybe we could try and find you to get out of here.
How do we do that?
Okay, I this is gonna end up hurting me, this, but I'm gonna give it a go anyway. I told Bing Bong I'll be right back, and I head back through the mist.
Don't go through the mist. I can't leave it, but everyone who's come through,
he points to like the plants and stuff like that,
they turn into compost eventually. I don't want to lose you. You're my only friend now.
Do you still go through the mist?
Just give me 1 second. Okay. Will I take psychic damage for going through the mist, or is it just straight up
unknown?
Unknown. Okay, I'm gonna head back through the mist.
Okay, you're gonna walk back through.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk back through.
Bing Bong's like,
no.
Make an intelligence saving throw.
As I'm doing this, I'm turn my head back and said I will be back shortly.
You pass again. You resist the magic. Let me move Kai's model. Kai, yeah, let's move your model. You move back through the mist. Successfully, Bing Bong's like, and the muffle as you pull your head through, you just kind of wince a little bit. You've resisted it, but something could have happened.
Okay, as I get back through, I tell everyone what's gone off so far. I explain to them that I want to try and save Bing Bong. I think it would be a great advantage to us.
A noble cause, Sir Kai. I'm sure dealing with Vecna will cure him of his curse.
I feel like we can pull some information out of him too if he's been dealing with her for so long.
Could I arcana check this mist to see, like, is it a magic effect that, I might be able to dispel?
Yeah, I mean, you just have to try to dispel the magic of Vecna.
Yeah, can I assist them?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely magical, and it has some type of, like, trying to think of spell school. Sometimes it's kind of tricky for me to think about that stuff. I'm going to say it's evocation or abjuration. Of course, it can try to be dispelled, as all magic can be. But depending on how powerful the wizard who cast it originally, it could be just more difficult. You want to try to dispel it?
Yes.
So I think how it works is you roll your spell attack roll again. It's first the spell DC of the creature. Or you can upcast your Dispel Magic to a higher level, to the actual level of whatever spell's been put down. You want to cast it as a higher level spell slot, maybe?
No.
You want to cast it as a third level spell for now?
Yeah.
Roll your attack roll.
So, 21.
Let me look up Vecna's spell save DC. I think it's 22. I think you missed by one.
Son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch. It's 22. You missed by one. You feel like it's wavering. The whispers, you see Bing Bong on the side. He's like, his little arms are up. He's like, as if the mist like comes back through. Bing Bong is still trapped.
Got too distracted.
Most unfortunate. I'm afraid I'm not willing to waste any more resources on this endeavor. I apologize, Kai. I tried the best I could.
Okay. I want to use Mind Link to, sorry, I did not learn anyone else's character names.
You can use Zoom, and in the lower left-hand side of everybody's Zoom, there's the name of the character, right?
Yeah, he's Rutherford. Yeah.
I'm gonna cast a mind link on him.
You're gonna cast a spell?
Yeah, I have a mind link.
Is that from your racial ability or something?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay.
You can speak telepathically to any creature you can see with it. Oh, I gotta see constantly.
Yeah, so it'll break as soon as you go through the mist.
Ah.
Lawyered.
Your luck is going to run out on those intelligence saves sooner or later, so going back and forth at will is probably not a good idea.
Probably not the best thing for you.
Just sticks his head back in casually. Hey, you good over there? Pop back over.
I go back through.
Yeah, and as he does go back through, I look at Rushford and Morgan's like, we could always, you know, get rid of it, and then I can bring it back and ask you a question if we ever need it.
Possibility.
It might be messed up, at least in Kai's eye, but...
Or we can just leave it be and continue onward.
That's very true. I don't feel like there's anything but the information that might be important out of this thing.
I believe Morgan has the right course of action in mind.
And plus, you already got the gear from him.
I got an idea.
You want to say it first before doing it?
Frightening when the barbarian says, I've got an idea.
You know, if I take Vankara across the dead corpse that I got, and take it to the other side and leave it there for him to have a friend, even though the skeleton's dead, and then we go back and come back later. Because there's got to be something in here what we can do or to get in free. And I'm pretty sure that we'd either get some sort of reward freedom.
And nothing better than a friend that caused you to be there. At least it looks like it.
I'd rather stay on good terms with it than we'll ditch it and come back later and it wants to kill us all.
put like a little like note with a BRB.
Is that what we're gonna do? We're gonna throw the corpse of Vecna through the mist.
I'm actually gonna go through.
Again?
Oh no!
I still have the rope on him.
Now, Kai, I did notice you having a bit of a wincing pain there as you went through the door. Could you elaborate on the sensation you had?
I'm guessing it was something that entering my mind, was it? And that felt like something.
No offense to your character, but I do not believe something attacking your mind is best for you to continue with such a rash action.
I'm gonna go anyway, unfortunately. As a knight, or a previous knight, should I say, I feel like I should do this.
Well, I see you do dumber things.
Well, I'm not going to stop you, however, I do advise strongly against it.
Thank you. I take it into consideration, but I still go.
I push him through.
Kai, you want to go through?
Yeah, I do want to go through.
You push him through, you like, make another saving throw.
My god.
You know I just know it!
I'm going to say you rolled a natural 20.
Yeah.
You've resisted the effect from the Archlich, whatever mist or whatever he's created here. Through conjuration, you're now immune to the effect. For this particular doorway, you rolled a natural 20.
Yeah,
three times. That's one in 8,000,
yes.
Right?
I did he roll 3 20s in a row?
Yeah,
yes. 3 20s.
No fucking way. Did he really?
Yes.
1 in 8,000 again.
I'm gonna be even. Are you serious? You rolled 3 20s?
Yeah. It's like me rolling my 3 natural 1s.
I got minus one as well.
You've totally resisted it. Describe how you destroy the mist.
He just wants a friend.
I'm just saying, you destroy it. Like, you feel like they're trying to enter your mind, and you've repulsed it, and you've totally countered their. You've totally countered. You rolled 3 fucking 20s in a row, man.
Nothing can enter a mind if there is no mind.
I'm going to say it's destroyed. You destroyed the mist. How do you destroy the mist?
As I go through, I feel like something's entering my mind one more time, but. Since I got psychic resistance due to my Kalishta feat, I have managed to resist it enough back to force it out of me as a shockwave of energy.
The shockwave of energy blows the mist back.
Yeah.
The curse holding Bing Bong has been broken. Bing Bong, with his flappy little leaf arms, comes up and gives you a hug. You free Bing Bong!
Oh, it's disgusting.
That's an unexpected creature you made a friend with there.
I told you I'd get you out of here any way I could. But since I did get you out of here, possibly could I take your bag? I currently don't have one.
You can take anything you want from Bing Bong.
Okay, as I, instead of carrying Vecna around, I'm going to carry around Bing Bong.
Put dirt in it and like let him sit in there.
He looks down at the corpse as you toss it and you say, I put down Vecna. He's like, that's not Vecna.
Well aware of the matter.
Yeah, we kind of thought that too.
Mind blown.
Big Bing Bong goes over, takes one of his like leafy little feet, like kicks the body. He's like, eh.
Gosh, you're abominable.
I'm sorry.
I said, there's no way to speak to a guest.
10 feet away from me, please.
Okay.
I equip all my gear back, put my line clock on so I'm no longer naked. I take the two potions from Vecna's body, or the broader lich corpse, and I crouch down in front of the plant, which is Bing Bong. And see if he wants to get on my back.
Yes, I will.
He like climbs up, his little leaf things goes around your shoulders. He's like securely attached. The leaves are kind of fuzzy. And he's like, you're my hero.
Yeah. I'm glad that I managed to get you over there.
Vecna cursed me and put me in this place and turned me into this plant. But you're so kind to Bing Bong. You don't insult me at all. And you help me so much. I'll never leave your side.
I was just trying to walk away in disgust.
You're my best friend.
I want to kill it so bad.
I go, you're my best friend too. Do you have any way of attacking since you're a plant, or are you just straight up passive?
Can before we go, can we say goodbye to my other friends?
He points over to the other plants that are here.
I don't quite show it to him, but my face squints inwards, like, almost, wow. But I go back into the room and I say goodbye to his plants.
Bye, Peter. Bye, Paul. Bye, Baron. Bye, Samuel.
He's like just saying goodbye to all of them. It takes 10 minutes for him to say goodbye to all his plants' names. Do we want to wait 10 minutes as he says goodbye?
I mean, I already started leaving, going to the next.
I tell the party to go on, we'll catch up.
Okay, let's move to the next room as the party separates. What do you want to do, Rutherford?
I'll take a short rest.
Rutherford wants to take a short rest as Bing Bong is saying goodbye to all of his plant friends.
You know what? I'm fine with that.
Yeah. Do you want to identify anything, Rutherford, over the short rest?
Oh, fuck. All right. I'll do a ritual. A ritual identify on the mace.
On the mace?
Yeah.
The strange ruins on the mace. Obviously, like a well-crafted forgery. The fool, most adventurers, the same with the programmed illusion. It was meant to hit any creature, allow any creature to be hit while they were in the chamber. So whoever wields the mace would have an automatic hit. No attack roll required. But just in that particular chamber. Maybe the magic could be extracted further to other places and locations. It would require further time and study to understand it all. Perhaps the artificers within the great halls of Stormbrook could figure it out. Welcome to Tomb of Horrors.
I believe we should travel back to town.
Do we continue, guys? Bing Bong, it's firmly attached onto Kai. Do we go to the next room?
Yep. Let me just roll some hit dice.
Yes, so one rule we have the healing surge action, Morgan. You can use your hit dice to heal yourself.
Yep.
Perfect amount, exactly what I needed.
Yeah, I was only down one hit point, so I just clicked off a hit die and called it a day. Because the plus would have healed that anyway, regardless of the roll.
Kai, can I tell you something, though?
Yes?
A long time ago, you know, before I met all my other friends, you know, my home, there was a bunch of these cultists who came by and they said they were sealing Vecna away. And that's why I haven't seen him in a long time, maybe. Just wanted to let you know that, buddy.
Thank you, buddy.
No problem.
I head over to Vecna's body, copy or whatever you want to call it, this right? Doppelganger.
Who takes the crown worth 25,000 gold?
I was just going to say, I take the crown worth 25,000
gold. It looks good on you, buddy.
Thank you, buddy.
Are you a king?
No. Just a great knight.
You are a great knight.
Knight in shining armor. Well,
separated. Let's not go that far.
Well, okay. As well as I try to break the skeleton head from the skeleton corpse, the lich.
Yeah, you want to take the head of this false thing?
Yeah. Okay. I want to stuff it into the bag.
Bing Bong goes,
ew.
You take the hat off, you rip it off, and you stuff it into the Bing Bong sack. You stuff it in there. He's like,
it's a special sack, my friend. Think about it. Put your hand in. Sack and think about the head.
Oh my god, I'm such an idiot. I derobe the lich and I put the robe on.
That looks good on you too. Not my quite my sense of style, but still pretty good.
I throw the cloak back to I guess it's Cypher's cloak. Was it not?
The bag is a bag of holding.
Yeah.
Ooh, it was. But yeah, the cloak was Cypher's.
Yeah. So you hand the loincloth. I think he just like tore off some clothing. Yeah. Or Cypher, did you hand him a cloak to, so he could garb himself? I think Cypher is toned out.
Sorry, my bad.
I blame you. Are we going to the next door, guys, or what's the plan?
Now, gentlemen, could I implore you to give this old man an extra 10 minutes just to re-catch my breath after having to cast that spell to identify that mace?
Well, if you're having another 10 minutes, can you re-identify it to see if we can move it to another room?
Well, that doesn't really serve the purposes that I need the rest for now, does it?
No, you're good.
You guys want to give me another 10 minutes for my short rest, or
go for it, old timer?
All right. Yes.
Oh, that's a point. The plants don't generally breathe underwater. I'm guessing the mist was somehow blocking most of the water back, wasn't it?
No, it was all underwater.
Okay.
It's a magic plant.
It's a magic fucking plant.
Vecna cursed me. I don't need to breathe or eat. He just kept me around to torment me before those cultists showed up.
This is the current time.
What did the cultists look like?
They dressed in black robes. They said they were going to seal Vecna away. And so he wouldn't hurt anybody anymore. I was happy, but they didn't let me go still, so I was still tormented, and I just had my friends. This right here, this hallway, this is like a whole new world for me. Thank you so much. You and your friends are just super.
Yeah, we are.
What do you guys do?
I mean, wait for the 10 minutes for a short rest, but
I've already had a consent. The short rest is over. I've had 10 minutes of timer. I've posted the time to the chat.
Do we want to push north?
I do believe that is a good direction to go.
Right. Yeah, I'd like to push north.
Cool.
100% like.
Yeah.
Does the guy or the plant on my back have any sort of attack abilities, or do I gain anything from attack abilities from him?
I'm just a plant.
What about those bracers that you found?
Do you maybe want to give him directions on how to get out of here?
Yeah.
It'll be dangerous if we go on.
We'll come back up.
All beat aside. Good thinking, Morgan. This character sure is a nuisance.
We could draw him a map or, like, you know, a way to get out.
Can you just, you know, take me out? You want to get rid of Bing Bong, or I'll just wait for you.
It'll be... There's bound to be a bunch of danger going on.
He whispers into Kai's ear. He's like,
perhaps.
He's like,
I'll wait forever.
Is he in like Starka level territory?
Okay, I want to put him down in this hallway next to the way out.
Okay, where do you want to put him?
Like here where I'm stuck.
How about this? I will give you command over Bing Bong's model.
Yeah, I was going to ask for that.
Here we go. There, your permission of Bing Bong.
Where is he?
So I'm going to put him there.
Okay.
And I say to Bing Bong, I'm going to leave you here because the ahead is dangerous.
I'll wait right here for you, buddy. But just don't forget about me. I've been alone for a long time.
I promised you before I came back, and I did. I'll come back again. It's a promise.
Okay. I'll see you soon.
I'll see you soon, too. As I start to walk down the corridor.
You hear, like, what is that? Is that the sound of underwater sniffling?
That's torturous. I carry on going, because I can't turn back and grab him, because it'll be dangerous ahead.
You come up to a door, Cypher. You search the door. Fucking false door. Are you fucking kidding me? It's a fake fucking door.
Oh,
you open the door, it goes fucking nowhere. What do you do?
Let's try the other side then.
I'm gonna wait here and I'm gonna show it to them that it's gonna be most likely another dead end.
You go down to the other door, guys?
While they go down to the other door, I'm gonna investigate down here to look for a secret door.
Behind the false door?
Yeah. Around in that area.
Okay, sure. So you're spending a couple more minutes to do it. I'm going to have Cypher, Rutherford, both roll dexterity saving throws as they trigger a trap as they open the door up. Rutherford fails. It's the classic ballista trap.
Natural 20.
No damage to you. But you take 2d8 damage. You take 9 piercing damage. Rutherford, as the ballista shims across your arm. It just has enough projectile power as it hovers in water. The ballista falls slowly to the ground. Your blood seeps out into there. Another fucking false door. It does not hit you. It doesn't have the projectile strength to get us all the way that far. It just hits Rutherford and these two guys.
Okay, since I see this projectile, I'm guessing come towards me a little and head to the floor.
Yeah, there's a spear right here.
I'm going to pick it up.
Okay.
I'm going to take it and put it in my bag of holding.
Give it to the plant.
Everything okay?
Bing Bong says as he's just standing like kind of close by.
He's like, I'm rooting for you, buddy.
You guys are just like walking back and forth through these hallways.
I'm actually going to try and hand the spear to Bing Bong. And see if he can use the spear.
He like takes his little plant arm to try to wrap around the spear. It doesn't really work. He can't hold the spear.
As he does that and he investigates, I'm actually going to go back to the plant room and see if there's anything there.
Before we do that, Morgwen finds something.
Ooh.
I'm trying to reveal it. It's tricky. This was one of the harder ones I fucked up with, maybe.
Evil.
Yeah. Tell me about it. Morgwen spends a few minutes looking through this area. He finds at the false door, there's another fucking secret door behind the fake fucking door.
The door behind the false door trick.
I'm gonna have you make a perception roll, Morgwino.
All right. 17.
You fail. The DC was 20. You slip through a trap. A slide opens up. I'll open this door for you, Morgwine. And I'm going to delete this fucking fake door right there. Right? That was, like, that was the idea of the model. I just didn't do it that well. But there is a pit trap right here. If I reveal it. See if I can do it. I think it's right here. You step into it. There's a slide. Okay, this is how it's done. Boom. You slide down. And you just fall right to here, I guess. Yeah, you just slide down a little bit into like an underground tunnel. Beyond that, it's just like it looks like the tunnel goes on for a while.
Okay. Is there any damage?
No damage.
Okay. Hello, fellas.
Hello, are you okay down there? Like you activated something.
Yeah, I'm fine. You might want to come down here with me, though. It looks like there's a passageway. Careful on your way down.
You guys continuing down this passageway that's under the ground here?
Yep.
What do you guys think about this new model? Pretty awesome, huh?
Yeah.
Cool. You come to, I'm going to reveal it. You're just walking down the passageway. No traps or anything like that. But it comes to another section here. Right here. The hallway extends under the ground. Do you guys want to do anything before we continue?
Well, I'm sorry. Can you spotlight where the passage, where you said there was another passage?
See, Morgwine, we've taken you right out of the tavern and thrown you right in the fire of Tomb of Annihilation. One of the most complex dungeons of all Dungeons and Dragons. you guys are not only under, you guys are fucking underwater doing this adventure too. Yeah. I'm popping my cherry on this one. This is my first underwater adventure, technically, I guess. You come up to a dead end, but it's really hard for me to do these secret doors and stuff, guys. Here's another fucking secret door. And I'll reveal the room.
Just call them doors at this point.
Yeah, pretty much. I'll remove it. Here we go. And it leads to another big room here that I've revealed. I'll describe the room, and I think that's where we're calling a session.
Okay. No.
Oh, let me describe the tunnel a little bit. This is an adamantine tunnel.
Oh.
The tunnel from the south emerges into a corridor and then heads east. The door at the end is a great block of adamantine. Oh, I messed up. The door, you see it. It's not a hidden door. I've removed it like an idiot, of course. That's okay. The door, there are three slots. On the door, they're about waist high. And they appear to be... they're like slits about this far and about that wide. What do you guys do? The animating blocks seem to be unmovable.
Does it seem like something that a thieves tool can possibly do?
You stick your thieves tools in there?
I feel like it should be a dagger or something.
You know, like, have that too.
Nothing happens when you stick your thieves tool in there.
What about if you stick a dagger into one of the holes?
You're like a click.
I am going to temporarily put down the dancing lights and use our last locate object.
To locate what?
Kai's, weapon.
You think about the adamantine double axe, right? Battle axe with two blades to it.
Yeah.
Getting close, a little warmer. But the direction is to the south, or I'm going to try to move your model's direction a little bit. Like this way, as you kind of walk around a cage, the heat a little bit. It's this way.
Or it's not up or down, it's just directly south?
Kind of up. A little bit up. As you kind of try to swim up to kind of gauge the three directional of it, it's faint. I'm going to add like a couple minutes of the timer for you to figure it out, though.
Well, if anything, do you think you just... want to take a bit of a long rest here?
Underwater?
But it's 24 hours.
Oh, right.
But a long rest is 24 hours, which we've only got one day.
No, it's not. 8 hours.
Oh.
But we lose our dark visions.
Yeah.
Oh, I get my spell slots back.
Yeah.
Put it back up.
I think while he's got locate objects on, I think he should move back through the hallways and see if he can go back to find it.
Well, we knew about that one-way door, right?
Rutherford's like blind right now. So if he starts doing it, like he's the only one without dark vision, so it's hard for him to do locate object or any other concentration spell without dropping the dancing lights. You're in quite a pickle.
What about if I pick him up and I carry him about that way?
Have him on your back, like while you run around?
Yeah, so okay. He keeps the concentration going and I'm the one who's moving him about.
Let me look it up for a second. But 1 second, let me look up the spell. I like the idea. This is what this dungeon needs, guys. It needs very creative solutions. You know, use your abilities and stuff like this. This is cool. So yeah, this is 1,000 feet. It's a concentration for 10 minutes. As he's carrying you around, I'm gonna just say you kind of carry him around the hallway a little bit as you're swimming with him on your back. You're like feeling out the edges of it, right?
Yeah.
Let me take a look here. You are certain that, let me just double check here real quick. You're certain that you're very close to, you're about a few hundred feet away, and it looks to be like we were just approximate through this room, which I've accidentally revealed. It looks to be like it could be over in, like, I'm going to try to highlight it with my flashlight. It's difficult, like right over here. Right.
Okay.
I don't see that. My camera's all gone all.
We know about that hallway door, though, right?
It's near. It's kind of weird. It's like, yeah, it's kind of near there. We're dealing in approximations, my friends.
I've deduced that Kai's gear is beyond this magical door here.
A great wizard indeed.
Welcome to the most convoluted fucking dungeon ever, guys.
So it is beyond the door.
What?
Maybe.
So it is beyond this door.
No, it's behind, I can't put flashlight down.
It's like in a hidden zone.
You see my bubble?
Yeah, it's in the bubble. Right. Yeah, I'll do the bubble for you. It's like...
And that's a one-way door.
I can't do it in 3D, right? But it's back here somewhere. It's like, I want to say, it's like, see where my bubble is jostling? That's kind of where it's at.
Okay. Can't I still move them about? Like, go back the way we came? And
you won't be able to open it. Because it's a one-way door. We discovered that earlier.
Well.
Now, I'm going to say this. Hold on. For instance, okay. Cypher, I'll say this. It's still just a door, though. It is a one-way door.
And somebody does have magical properties to open it.
Yes, it has magical properties to do it. I'm gonna say it has the same properties of this door right here where I've tried. It's built out of adamantine, and there's more magic involved with it. Do you guys want to end the adventure here?
Let's take a long rest.
You guys also want to take a long rest?
Before we do the long rest, I would like to just do 5th level dispel magic on that door.
Which door? The one-way door? Or the door in front of you down in the big room?
Oh. He has one.
I got 2 5th level spell slots, and we're going to take a long rest, and might as well do it on both of them.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to say you cast it on one of the doors. I'll say you do it on the one-way door for starters.
All right. With Kai's gear.
Make an arcana roll.
All right.
As you cast a dispel magic, it doesn't work.
Oh.
You roll very high. There appears to be an anti-magic spell on it. So being unfit, you cannot use magic to open it up.
Probably shit ton of loot.
But I want to dispel it.
There's some type of field, an anti-magic field, or anti-magic property that's been embedded into the animantine.
Oh, my.
This might be a weird question, but can you somehow detect if this still comes from the lich? Like, if somehow the glitch is killed, it might be a lot easier to open.
Killing the lich would be a lot easier if we could get Kowski.
I'll have an... Unknown.
Unknown.
I mean, I know the answer is the DM, but the answer is unknown.
It's just an educated guess.
No, that's good. I like you guys thinking about this. I like that.
I have an out-of-game question. Would it be possible to use two spellcasters to cast one spell as if they were channeling energy into the other person to get a propose for an advantage?
Yes.
Oh.
Okay. Can we give that a try?
You're going to try it? I'm going to say, I'm going to tell Rutherford, this door, no amount of magic will be able to pierce through it. It has an anti-magic field property to it. It would require very powerful magic, aka like ninth level spells, to like probably go through it.
Can I hit it with the mace?
The mantide?
You said the mace, yeah.
Yeah, you hit the mace up against it, no effect.
Oh. What about this front door right here?
You want to try the other dispel magic on the other doorway with the three slots? Correct?
Sure. Yeah, we'll do that one too.
No effect. Same issue. Anti-magic. Whatever is behind these doors must be locked up tight.
Well, you seem tugged out, old man. I think it's time for us to get some rest.
As Morgan lets out a giant yawn.
There's one thing I want to try.
Okay.
I've already put the dagger into one of the hole slots, and you said there was a click. Can I try and put a spear into the hole and see if there's another click?
Hole. You put the blade into the spear in there, you kind of jostle it a little bit. You're another click.
I feel like we should save the last one.
Yeah. I'm thinking the same.
Yeah, that's why we have a moment of peace.
Alright.
You guys want to wait till next game to solve it?
Yep,
I want a long rest wait till next game.
So here's what we're going to do. Here's one cool thing about this dungeon, basically. We're under fucking water, guys. There's no, like, random encounters or anything in this dungeon. Like, it's just like a frustrating heap of secret doors and traps. Right? So you can take, like, long rests, you know, as much as you want, right? And the idea is to challenge you as a player to really be creative and think through these solutions and puzzles, really. You go through a long hitch completely unhindered. It's obviously, like, terrifying. You guys are sleeping, like, deep under the lake, right? It's dark. It's cold. But you do have a long rest.
I've got a solution for that.
Okay.
In the corner, you know, where the passageway bends.
Yeah, like right here?
Yep, I'm going to ritual cast
Lehman's Tiny Hut. Yeah.
Yep.
Hell yeah.
Finally. Warm fires. Not even a magnificent mansion. Come on, dude. This is level 10.
I'm not high enough level.
I think it's a 6th level spell. I'm just pulling your change.
Yeah. As soon as we get in there, I whip out my cigar case.
There you go. Cigars all around.
Savior.
Indeed, and I take my bagpipes and I start pushing on them to get the water out of them. And
would you like the cigar yourself, sir?
I wonder if Bing Bong can get in here.
We want to bring Bing Bong up to the tent?
No,
I do not need to bring him along now.
No, the magic will not allow Bing Bong in the space. Oh, I'm sorry, I don't know. I must have miscast the spell. I wasn't thinking of you when I cast it.
I think he's a water-based plant, so it's probably not smart.
There you go. He'll dry out.
Isn't this map awesome, though?
It is.
Yeah.
Before we end, can I try something else?
What else do you want to try? One last thing.
I figured if we're having a long rest, I want to give it a try anyway, just in case.
Sure.
It says I can commune with nature.
Okay. Yeah, there's no, like, fishes or anything like that around, really.
No, but it says I can get knowledge on buildings and influence from other planes of existence, isn't
it? Okay, we're busting out the big boy spells. I like it. So this is just a level... This is a level 5 spell. It takes 1 minute to cast. Yeah, you're just getting in tune with the surrounding territory. I like it. It gives you knowledge of the land within 3 miles of you. Caves and other natural settings and things like that. Limit to up to 300 feet. So, like, we're underground, so this would be up to 300 feet. You gain knowledge of three facts. The terrains and type of body, plants, minerals, and so forth, powerful celestial phase, demons, and undead, and influences from other planes of existence and buildings. I'll give you three facts then, okay, as you commune with nature, okay? You ready?
Yeah.
There is a very powerful undead nearby. And it could be Vecna. That's fact number one. Number two, whatever is behind this door is like, it's sealed off and warded by your magic. Like, you can't get into it. As you like close your eyes and you begin to feel the water enter your ears and you just reach out with a little bit of senses. Three, God, this dungeon sucks. No, there's just powerful warding. Like, you've entered an area of the dungeon where it's like kind of been warded. So it's difficult to sense what's beyond this door, right? I'll tell you one thing though. You do sense, I'll tell you two other kind of minor things about this. It goes up to 300 feet since we're underground. You do sense a large tunnel. And I will reveal it on the map. A tunnel that almost reaches down to the bottom that you didn't spot before, but you feel it. You guys see I put the tunnel out in the middle of the map?
Yes.
And you see these are the types of spells like designed for like this kind of high level style dungeon. So if you do school spells and effects like that, that's what this is about. That tunnel, as you feel it and you sense it, it reaches up all the way to the top, almost all the way up to the surface level of where that room was at, the hallway where you came down. Maybe you missed something. Who knows?
Maybe a way out.
Unknown. And that concludes our adventure for today. Did you guys have fun?
Hell yeah.
Did you like it, Cypher? Or you seem like a little tired today, buddy.
No, I'm loving it.
Okay, cool.
I thought it looked a bit annoying, to be honest, but other than that.
Did you guys like Bing Bong?
No. Yes. I hate more than Ian Parnish.
Ian Parnish.
Strong hatred.
It yes. just sounds like the character from Rick and Morty.
Yeah, I gotta watch that video. It's gonna be funny.
Yeah, yeah.
I absolutely hate him. I kind of like him, but I absolutely hate him.
This dungeon's pretty fun to run. It's not the style of dungeon I would make personally. I would want more like creatures and things, you know, more living creatures in the dungeon and stuff.
Less secret doors.
Well, just like this dungeon is just filled with secret doors and traps everywhere. I think we're going to finish this next week. There's still a few more little challenges that might put you guys in a thing, but definitely I think we should be able to finish it by next week. And I guarantee you guys are going to have, there'll be some interesting stuff. So the way I do stuff with one shots is, yeah, you have characters and stuff like that, but it does have permanence on the world, like their stories remain. Similar with like Khordar and Azul, how we took those characters from one shots and brought them into the other campaigns. So like if you find items or do things or stories related to this, there's persistence through other games if you want to bring those characters along for other games.
Cool.
I'm thinking about running a game, though there's two games. There's game times I'm thinking about running. Morgwine says he wants to play on Saturdays during this particular time slot. Is that correct?
Yeah, if not a little bit earlier, like 1 or 2 p.m. would be great. Just way we if you know, we finish up like around dinner time, that'd be great.
Do you guys kind of like that idea? Well, I know some of you guys are in the other games. We're still running the Sunday game. It'll be a paid $15 game. I'm also planning on running maybe a game on Wednesday. Yeah, it'll be Wednesday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It'll be similar idea, homebrew campaign. I just want to run as many games so I don't go crazy, like Morgleen's XDM.
Yeah.
You know, taking on too much, you know, that type of idea. The Sunday game is totally cool. Our Monday game is going to end, and I don't know if I'm going to run a game in that slot yet. But if I do, I'm thinking it's going to be a streamers-only game where I invite other streamers and just do a streamers-only game on Monday. That's just my idea right now.
I better stop streaming quickly then.
It gets you hooked? Guy, what'd you think about Talespire Morgwine?
I'm a big fan. As a matter of fact, I'm after last week's experience, I've tried to talk my other GM into paying attention to it. I sent him the link to this stream to see if he'd watch it for a while to determine whether or not we've been using Roll20, and Roll20 is just such a drag.
Oh, God.
You know, it's just so bad. And I just keep trying to talk him into every few weeks, like, hey, man, you know, there's really good technology out there that will make this a lot more immersive. You know, but
I mean, if he doesn't want to deal with like 3D stuff, use Foundry VTT.
Yeah, yeah, I'm trying to get him in this direction.
Yeah,
I'm a big fan of this. When the model first came up, and you put us in the altar room or the church or whatever you wanted to call it, I just started zooming around like, ooh, look at that! Oh, hell, that's great. The 3D environment's really cool.
This room up ahead, you guys can you see all the pillars that this guy put in?
Yeah, it's a lot of work.
It's cool. So actually, I you know, since I do pay DM type stuff, I reinvest a lot of that money and I'll buy other maps. Like, that's how I met Kai, actually, is he was another DM. We just met up through a casual thing, but he's a pretty good map designer. Plus, I also subscribe to other map creators to get really pro maps. Some of them, they just post them live to Tales Tavern, which is like a database or community database for maps, and that always helps.
Is Talespire able to import assets, or do you have to use their...
No, you have to use their assets, what's in the game currently, but you can in and take in and out from the game. So Talespire has its own like little website called Tales Tavern where you can pull slabs or boards itself into the game.
But you can add in custom assets too.
Yes.
Okay.
You can if you use a mod, I believe, and you can pull in stuff from Blender what you've created yourself. But when I took it to look into that, there was a lot of mucking about bringing on your own assets.
Oh, okay.
Alrighty. I'll see you guys later.
See ya.
Like, take one care. Other thing I've done is, you know, I take the money we make from this too, and I invest it into some of the models. So yesterday I bought not only the pro subscription for Hero Forge, but I also bought some hero packs or the model packs and stuff for that. If they come up, you know, it's just, and also I love supporting other creators. So that's why I Patreon a lot of these other guys. And I plan on also using the money to buy more ambience stuff from this pro ambience guy and put it in that in our database. But he's got like 7 or 8 volumes of it and it needs to be organized. It's just a lot of time. You got to organize it, then upload it, and then put it together. But that helps me when I'm building out the encounter stuff. Cool, man. That's right. Pretty much it from my end. Unless you guys, I'm here to stay if you guys want to chit-chat.
I'm good. I got another D&D game I'm about to get.